Check it. Look, it's a cold world. They still slaughtering the Jews like a wholesale. Ain't trying to turn on the news, I'm seeing all hell. They trying to catch all my juniors, them jails Odell. We in a spot where the hitters be. All they know is drama and nicotine. The sticks we got, give them epiphanies. Nigga, you kidding me? Ain't no flip that could get you as lit as these. The script turned a crip into mystic clean. That's really the plan, though. Had us chained with the minds and manacles. Couple verses, now they thought sabbaticals. We international, that's a booster for the sick and the weak. We got the missions moving, lifting the speed. I'm in the league with commandos, creasing a pants though, seeking a beast till the cease be his handle. That's the results when the saints pop out. We in the paint until the space pop out. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. They say I'm too black, so I don't fit in the system. Miseducated, but somehow we got wisdom. These niggas ain't looking the same. Crash course about the Jews going missing. Black men forced fed a religion. They tried to stretch us far, but couldn't break our bands. We held tight.
I have important news.
I'm angry, but what do? I know my silence on a topic doesn't make things better. I speak up. I know my influence could bring change. I'm more patient now, knowing that we've been through pain. This is the breakthrough. To raise a family, it takes two. But missing fathers was forced on us. I never knew my pops. This whole system was shot. It was a system I blamed. We never had a relationship. The closest we got was exchanging names. Prison doors had pops. Tried to confine walls and spaces. Mistakes he made landed him in bad places. Damn, no wonder why I hate these races. Just to see him make the right choices in life, I switched places. Knowing just the impact on my life, I needed that. This is the story of men who black, but who got our back? I looked high and saw a black guy. Praise of his saints. These songs are so sweet. Until that day, praise to the east. I'm a feast with my brethren. Joy and peace with my brethren. Who really ready for the kingdom of heaven? Yeah.
Okay, we pull up in the hood where they say it ain't safe. It's all good, little nigga, we straight. We ain't doing nothing wrong. We just trying to be great.
See, the sun is about to set.
But your obligation should be this company. You should have, you know, this should come first, right?
Listen, I gave you a 40. And if you need overtime on Christmas and so-called New Year's, you got me. But it's Friday evening, and I got to go.
I'm not sinning for a dollar. I'm so below to my father. I get sick days only to earn my money. Won't trim my ways. The seventh is your day. Yeah. Cargos pressed up. Campbell's polish. Bible. This is all that I need.
All praises to the Father.
A day of rest, 24 hours, no stress.
All praises to the Father.
I clocked out, now it's time to scream and shout. All praises. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Making bread is not my life. Keep his love to survive. Pay my bills, I'm alright. You woke me up, yeah.
You chose me.
I'm at camp early.
In the streets.
I'm your employee.
All is true.
So pay me. Cargo.
All praises.
praise to the Most High. I'm just a vessel. Vessel of a potter.
I feel my heartbeat. I said to my people, my spirit is dying inside of me. My brothers are weak. They just trying to eat. The devil is testing the God of me. I know I'm just clay, but Father, you made me. I'm hoping you molding this pottery. They pressing my buttons. Ain't talking about nothing. You know it's a whole nother side of me. I feel my heartbeat. I said to my people, my spirit is dying inside of me. My brothers are weak. They just trying to eat. The devil is testing the God of me. I know I'm just clay, but Father, you made me. I'm hoping you molding this pottery. They pressing my buttons. Ain't talking about nothing. You know it's a whole nother side of me. I'm walking this life like I'm walking on crutches. Cleaning the Father, no. I've been just strutting. I've been through a lot and it just made me tougher. Pain in my eye when you see me in public. Look me in the eyes, your man is nothing. Keep your head up, you a strong young brother. Reminding myself when I'm down in the gutter and seeing my brothers despise one another. Making it easy for these undercovers. Smiling your face with their head undercover. Waving their badge and then leaving you bloody. Then pay for their freedom through lawyers and judges. They pressing my buttons, I'm holding my peace. My cool as a fan, but I'm caging the beast. Can't wait for their time to be up on the lead. So the lion inside me can hunt for the feast. I feel my heartbeat, I said to my people, my spirit is dying inside of me. My brothers are weak, they just trying to eat. The devil is testing the God of me. I know I'm just clay, but Father, you made me. I'm hoping you more than this pottery. They pressing my buttons, ain't talking about nothing. You know it's a whole nother side of me. I feel my heartbeat, I stand on my feet, but my spirit is dying inside of me. My brothers are weak, they just trying to eat. The devil is testing the God of me. I know I'm just clay, but Father, you made me. I'm hoping you more than this pottery. They pressing my buttons, ain't talking about nothing. You know it's a whole nother side of me.
I'm just the work of the Lord, doing the work of the Lord. Don't honor me. This life is an art exhibit, it's a gift to me. I'm just a piece of the pottery. Might not have been broken to pieces. Seen things you wouldn't believe. It's a blessing to be alive. Live in this time, you have a shot, gonna redeem a show when they see you, show.
The prince of the power, I'm putting my life on the line, forever indebted, and every day like the Passover, man, I'm purging my sin, removing the leaven, and rising up from the valley of dry bones. Yeah, you know that my focus on heaven, build up with the brethren, receiving the blessing, and live for the kingdom, yeah, this is the message.
I feel my heartbeat, I stand on my feet, but my spirit is dying inside of me. My brothers are weak, they just trying to eat, the devil is testing the God of me. I know I'm just clay, but Father, you made me, I'm hoping you more than this pottery. They pressing my buttons, ain't talking about nothing, you know it's a whole nother side of me. I feel my heartbeat, I stand on my feet, but my spirit is dying inside of me. My brothers are weak, they just trying to eat. The devil is testing the God of me. I know I'm just clay, but Father, you made me. I'm hoping you more than this pottery. They pressing my buttons, ain't talking about nothing. You know it's a whole nother side of me.
Born a prophet, but a slave I was made. After 25 years, a whole lot of tears. They let a lion out his cage. We full of scars, so we ran together. The word of God given me. I'm walking through the fire without a burn mark, scratch or a graze. That mean I ain't looking phased. Stand 10 toes, and my brothers with me. Ain't no standing alone. I had to repent on my own. Ain't no turning back when I get in the zone. You know I've been through the pain, and it's all worth it. I've been going through change. You know I've been caging the beast, and I'm trying to eat, and it's hard to tame.
I feel my heartbeat, I stand on my feet, but my spirit is dying inside of me. My brothers are weak, they just trying to eat. The devil is testing the God of me. I know I'm just clay, but Father, you made me. I'm hoping you more than this pottery. They pressing my buttons, ain't talking about nothing. You know it's a whole nother side of me. I feel my heartbeat, I stand on my feet, but my spirit is dying inside of me. My brothers are weak, they just trying to eat. The devil is testing the God of me. I know I'm just clay, but Father, you made me. I'm hoping you more than this pottery. They pressing my buttons, ain't talking about nothing. You know it's a whole nother side of me.
Pushing the hardest, you know it's the purple and gold. Whether you win it or not, if you're pushing the truth, I'm saluting, I'm with you, my bro. End of the day, we don't count it for profit, cause all that we do, he done did it before. Gotta admit, I ain't listened before. Gotta repent, I admit I was slow. They like who we think he is, how he speaking against him when you was stealing with hoes. They like who we think he is, how you ride for your nation, you used to just ride for your bros. Don't understand, I'm repenting, cause I'm for the Lord and I wanna kill all of my foes.
I got God on my side, he's not gonna pay for his crimes. It's a gon' pay for his lies. I won't drink of your wine. I want you to pay for your life. I want you to pay for your lies. Handle our business. Pay for your suit and your tie. I got
I got God on my side. Issa gon' pay for his crimes. Issa gon' pay for his lies. I won't drink of your wine. I want you to pay for your life. I want you to pay for your lies. Handle our business. Pay for your suit and your tie.
I'm seeking vengeance. I'm seeking death and destruction on the spawn of Satan. When kingdom arrives, we'll leave all your lies. We'll get thrown in a pit and your land overtaken. Death and destruction, there is no mistake. Eternal damnation, you will be forsaken. You stole on our lands and you broken our bands. We'll leave when I get the chance, I'm going crazy. Blood flowing off the garment like it's gravy. Planet invasion from a stellar navy. Man, you messing with the god of war. Leave your arms severed and your face cold. Hand being fired like a quasar. No protection from it, no fire guard. Bite the vein off your neck, it'll leave you marred. I'm a jaw titan like I'm Galliard.
I got God on my side. He's not gonna pay for his crimes. He's not gonna pay for his lies. I won't drink of your wine. I want you to pay for your life. I want you to pay for your lies. Handle our business. Pay for your suit and your tie. I got God on my side. He's not gonna pay for his crimes. He's not gonna pay for his lies. I won't drink of your wine. I want you to pay for your life. I want you to pay for your lies. Handle our business. Pay for your suit and your tie.
You gonna pay for your lies. Coming through ripping up, eating my stride. Guarantee that fake will make it west by to the nation. Cremation and leaving you fried. Look in my eyes, can't you see the pain? 400 years in captivity, man. You ain't gonna pay for what's it, but you went overboard with the raven and slinging and burning and leaving us hanging on trees. Shit on your knees, and they gonna see if you gon' plead. Pay for your life and we show no remorse, cause you showed us no mercy. You left with the perjury. Look in your cup for me, look at the devil, leave back and he's sipping the jacks of destruction, corruption. There's ending no chance of repentance. No more eat of my slave.
I got God on my side. He's not gonna pay for his crimes. He's not gonna pay for his lies. I won't drink of your wine. I want you to pay for your life. I want you to pay for your lies. Handle our business. Pay for your suit and your tie. I got God on my side. He's not gonna pay for his crimes. He's not gonna pay for his lies. I won't drink of your wine. I want you to pay for your life. I want you to pay for your lies. Handle our business. Pay for your suit and your tie.
Hey, shalom, shalom, Israel, Most High, and Christ blessed. All praise to the Most High. Happy Sabbath.
That's right.
Shout out to the mighty, mighty Deacon ASAP, man, tonight.
That's right.
IUIC Arkansas is blessed with the privilege.
That's right.
The rare privilege.
Right.
To hold down Friday Night Raw. Y'all better wake the hell up.
That's
I know it's
right.
late. Hey, shout out to Deacon Abiel, man. Some faces got fixed. I know all the nationwide haters.
Man.
All the Canary Mission.
Oh,
the damn. I used to know. Wake
SPLC,
up.
Yep.
SPLC.
Yep.
The BBs. The ADL. I know you haters, man.
Right.
I know you pissed that hell off right now.
I know it.
Like Bishop said, I know they sitting back there trying to count.
How many of them niggas?
You know what I'm saying? Trying to look through the videos, funnel through the videos to see how many we got wearing all that. Hey, keep watching.
Keep on.
You understand? Because it ain't no way the gates of hell will not prevail.
Hell no.
All praise to the Most High. That was an excellent show right there. Fix your faith.
That's right.
All
right.
So, yes, we on pretty late. All right. But it is what it is. We still going to get it in.
That's
still gonna get it in. All right. But like Captain O.C. said in that video when he said, I'm not Bishop Nathaniel. I'm not Deacon ASAP.
Right.
I'm not Deacon ASAP. But, hey, let me see if I can do my Hey,
bring it out.
Nah, I gotta wait for the moment. I gotta wait for the moment to try to get it in, man. Try to get my young Deacon ASAP impression here. But y'all know what it is, man. Who I got with me tonight? I'm Captain Emmanuel, IUIC Arkansas. Who I got with me to the right?
Officer Baruch.
Officer Hezekiah.
Officer Davi.
My left.
Officer Jonah.
Officer. All right, oh, bro, y'all taking too damn long. All right, the man is already late. They already sleeping. Damn.
Sleep.
Oh, Kevin, all right, man. Oh, bro, so as y'all can see, the topic is television. All right? Now, we ain't always heard with just the word, the etymology of television.
Right. Mm-hmm.
They telling you a vision.
Right.
And black people have never, ever ran television.
Right. Hell, you understand? No. Right,
facts.
The closest we done got to it thus far is 50 Cent and damn Power. And BMF.
Right.
We don't even run Tubi. You thought we ran Tubi, didn't it? No.
Hell
no. Yeah, we can show some content on that. I saw a video on that. But I'm going to leave that alone. We're going to leave that alone today. Right. All right? But the vision that they telling you in television, that the white man is telling you,
right,
is a lie. They literally trying to formulate your thoughts onto how you should act, how you should deal with your brother, your sister, based on the imagery that they provide you.
Right.
It ain't even your reality. They are creating, they are formulating your reality through a screen. Yep. You understand? And our people have been lied to. Television is one of the biggest forms of lies that they've been able to push to control and manipulate our people's minds.
Right.
Come on,
to
now,
think
dog.
Less of themselves. You understand? And think less of their neighbor. It is what it is. So tonight we're going to talk about it. And there is a reason for the season.
That's right.
All right? Now, me personally, I'm a very young man. It is what it is. Very young man. But I'm a grown man, though. I got wife, kids, all that. Don't get it twisted. But I'm young. Currently, years, not many. So I never seen an episode of Good Times. I don't know much about the show. But I know it's one of the most popular shows ever.
Definitely.
I know a little bit of the tune of the intro. How it go?
Good Times.
Good time. Yeah, I know a little something, right?
Come on now, dog.
And, you know, as kids, somehow we learned the little quote, dynamite, right? But they have recreated this thing in 2024. And guess what? Now, you know, they say it's the woke era and all of that. So they got a part to play in it.
What?
But they saying that black people are not feeling it. On social media, in the comment section, in the review reaction videos,
right,
black people is not feeling it.
Hell,
you understand?
No.
Now, some of y'all, man, I didn't find out about this till today myself. So a lot of y'all watching might not know what the hell I'm talking about. So we gonna play you the clip. They got the internet going crazy. The trailer for the new cartoon version, the recreation of the 70s show Good Times. Play that for us. Come on.
Let me guess. The state called and they want to cut you a disability check for your face.
Hold up. You can get paid for that?
This is from a fool who stares at his orange juice every morning.
It says concentrate on the box. Who the dummy now?
Shit. Me for not wearing a condom.
Woo!
Shadows fall over my heart.
It all started with my grandfather, James Evans. My job as the man of this house is to take care of this family no matter what.
I just want to let you know, I'm going to take good care of Gray.
Gray, who is this n- I'm about to kill?
Juan, my boyfriend. Daddy, let him go.
Baby, you should come with me.
Junior's repeating the 10th grade for the third time.
Is there anything you can suggest to help him get to the drive-thru?
Can you do OnlyFans? Take off your shoes. Let me see what kind of feet you're working with.
To the dark side.
Dear Black Heavenly Father,
College Redeemer,
if you could just help us.
Son, it's for you.
New phone, who this?
All black, everything.
At least they ain't got that drug dealing baby under my roof no more.
Man, my mouth ready for some milk right now.
Dalvin, why are you so breast obsessed?
It's childish, man.
Bruh, I'm a baby. I can't get no more childish than that.
In a nocturnal state of mind.
Your neighborhood is a real shithole.
It's the system. They put the guns and drugs on the streets.
Underneath this black, black sky.
This is getting dangerous. I won't just sit back and let you put yourself in harm's way.
I love you too damn much.
Everything black.
The revolution will not be televised.
Come on, Rosa Parks, can't you just enjoy this?
We're just as good as the Evans of old.
Isn't that just dynamite?
But the truth is, we're the Evans of new.
Bitch, you look like money.
Everything black.
What about the struggle?
We're black. It'll be here tomorrow.
Everything black.
Wait a minute. The baby? Little baby? And baby baby?
Too many babies around this crib.
There you go. There you go, Israel. Now, like I said, I just seen this for the first time a few hours ago.
What?
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so I was under a rock. I ain't know nothing about this. So I'm pretty this a lot of y'all time, first time seeing it. Now, for those of y'all that's old enough that hadn't been in witness and watched the old good times, I'm pretty sure you're deeply offended.
Fag, that's totally
different. Are you serious?
But yeah, it's a lot in there. It's a lot in there. It's a lot to say. But I wanna dial back a little bit. I wanna backtrack a little bit. All right, because this is Friday Night Raw. You know how Deacon Asaph do it. Deacon Asaph is very interactive. You know what I'm saying? He read the comments in the chat and stuff like that, and he responds to us. So I want you brothers and sisters, you know, because y'all going in on the chat, I'm already seeing it. All right, so we gonna be interactive tonight. Right. You understand? We gonna interact with y'all. So all praise to the Most High. I just want to put that out there. And also, before we get started, it was something else I had wanted to say. Now it's slipping my damn mind. The hell is this? Oh, yeah. While I'm thinking about it, subscribe to IUIC Arkansas real quick.
That's right.
Go ahead and subscribe to IUIC Arkansas. Let's Talk Truth Radio every Friday, 4 p.m. Eastern. You understand? But yeah, we finna get into it, man. Tell Lie Vision. As you can see from that trailer right there, they are pushing hella stereotypes and propaganda to, you know, basically keep our minds in the gutter as far as when we think about our people, all right, and how we live and the way that we do stuff in this entertainment. You understand?
Right.
And you would think, okay, we done had enough of that. Oh, I know what was in my mind. So one of the creators of the show, writers, creators, whatever, is Steph Curry. Ain't that interesting?
I seen that. I was wondering who was that Stephen Curry that they had.
The number 30, the ball player. The light skinned brother.
Right.
The light skinned brother. I had to say that twice.
You don't find that suspicious.
The light skinned brother.
Very
yes. So he's involved with this. All right. Get Leviticus 26:17. So I want to start with this scripture right here. Now, of course, they got black voices. They got a few black players involved or whatever the case. But at the end of the day, we know who's really behind this, whose hand is pushing this to the forefront. It's Sony. Sony and Netflix, which is owned by Esau. And, of course, it's other Edomite, you know, Caucasians that's dealing with the production, creation of the show, the content. All right? So let's read this scripture real quick. Read that.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 26 and verse 17.
Come on.
And I will set my face against you, and ye shall be slain before your enemies. They that hate you shall reign over you.
Read that again.
They that hate you shall reign over you.
The Bible says, speaking to the Israelites in the book of Leviticus, the whole entire Bible, you understand, but the law specifically, the Bible says it was appointed to the children of Israel. And that's what we read in the book of Leviticus, the law, right? And in this chapter in particular, these are judgments for breaking his laws. One of the judgments that will be upon the nation of Israel for breaking God's laws is that them that hate you shall reign over you. You understand? So the people that produce, well, your food, your drink.
Right.
You understand? The water you use to bathe yourself, your clothes, all of your basic necessities, and including your entertainment. The people that will be behind that and push that and provide that for you or approve what can be provided for you is those that hate you. You understand? So if the people that hate you is responsible for what you consume on a daily basis over and over and over again, what do you think they pushing for you?
Right.
Self-hatred. That's why they got the mama in there. Which was contrary. Now, we going to dig into the original good times that was a hot-ass mess to begin with. You understand? But this is a to the 10th power of evil, an upgrade of evil imagery to our people. Now the mama got, what, blonde weave in her head?
Right.
The baby sell dope.
You can't make
and we
this
know
stuff
what's
up
behind it because one of the main writers is the same man that created Family Guy. We're going to get into that. Esau, Edomite, yes.
Right.
I understand. But a baby selling dope. The daddy a bum.
The
you understand?
Flunked 12th grade how many times they said.
Right. He failed a certain grade 5-6 times.
You can't make this stuff up.
Right? So that's what happens when them that hate you reign over you and are responsible for how you're represented
right
and the vision that they tell. Right. Tell of it, tell a lie, vision. You understand? Now give me Psalms 137. Psalms chapter 137 and verse 3. All right?
The book of Psalms chapter 137, verse 3.
Now, the reason why entertainment has such a... It's a lot of reasons why, right? Entertainment has such a big impact on our culture and the way that we view ourselves and treat ourselves, right? One of the main reasons is it's one of the more rewarding, as far as what we can see, one of the more rewarding fields for our people, especially the majority of us growing up in poverty. You understand, we never been nowhere, we never had nothing, so on and so forth. So when you see people on TV, you automatically assume that they rich.
Right.
They famous, everybody know them. You understand? They are the star figures to our people. They are what it was supposed to be. Our doctors and lawyers, you know, the people that are very essential to society, mm-hmm. and their success reflects that. We don't really have it. We go straight from working at Walmart to damn rappers and actors.
Come on, man.
Ain't no lawyers and doctors and all that in between that. You understand?
Yeah, no.
So we hold these things to a very, very high regard that has a major influence on our people, you understand? And guess what? The Bible tells us the root of that. Let's read that real quick. Come on.
For there they that carried us away captive required of us a song.
So it says, for there. Jump up to verse 1.
Verse 1.
Come on.
By the rivers of Babylon.
By the rivers of Babylon. Now you might be asking yourself, right? The rivers of Babylon. Is that talking about ancient Babylon, which is over there in the east, modern day Iraq? Hell no. All right, the rivers of Babylon is talking about the shores of the Gulf of Mexico, Atlantic Ocean. Yeah, you understand? Mm-hmm. Well, we got dropped off at in America because America is Babylon the Great.
That's
and
right.
we can prove that quickly. Jump up to verse 7 real quick. Read that.
Verse 7.
Come on.
Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom.
The children of who?
The children of Edom.
The children of Edom is the so-called white man in the earth.
Right.
Who, according to the Bible, was born red.
Right.
Hairy all over. That's why his name is Edom. Edom means red.
The devil.
So the Bible says, remember, O Lord, the children of Edom. Come on.
In the day of Jerusalem.
Uh-huh.
Who said, race it. Even to the foundation thereof.
Right. So they were the ancient Babylonians' major cheerleaders when they came to destroy our temple. As a matter of fact, the Edomites, the ones that set it on fire.
What?
So David prophesied that name in the spirit. The Lord showed it to him. Now watch this. Read on.
O daughter of Babylon.
What did he call Edom?
O daughter of Babylon.
So the children of Esau in the Bible is known as the daughter of Babylon, who would eventually, by the time you get to Revelation, is that great whore,
right?
Babylon the Great.
This is America.
You understand? That's talking about the children of Edom. Now, give me Zechariah 2 real quick just to get a geographical location. Zechariah chapter 2, verse 6, real quick.
The book of Zechariah chapter 2 and verse 6.
Come on.
Ho, ho, come forth and flee from the land of the north.
So this is the message to God's people. The same one in Revelation 18 and 4. Come out of her, my people, right? Come out of the ways, the sins that you've been taught. But look at what the Bible calls it. Read it again.
Ho, ho, come forth and flee from the land of the north.
So flee from the land of the north. Now, when you look at a world map, any world map, mm-hmm. right? It's seven continents, right? Now, this one that we're in just so happens to be the only continent with the word north in it.
You don't find that suspicious?
Right?
Amazing.
Am I tripping?
No, you're not tripping.
We are on a continent known as North America.
Right.
So God has a message to his children on the continent of North America. Come forth out of the lies that they have told you mm-hmm. in a vision called television. You
that's
understand?
Right.
That's one of the messages that God is giving here, right? That falls under the sins that you have been taught here. Go ahead.
Saith the Lord.
Come on.
For I have spread you abroad as the four winds of the heaven,
read.
Saith the Lord.
Come on.
Deliver thyself, O Zion,
uh-huh.
that dwellest with the daughter of Babylon.
So wait a minute. The children of Zion, the Israelites, who were carried away captive, are dwelling in the land of the north with the daughter of Babylon, who is the children of Edom.
Right.
See how easily we connected them dots?
Like simple.
Why your past ain't never did that? You understand? Why I never learned that in church?
Right.
All,
right.
Them, right. all them years. All that damn Sunday school. For what?
Shame
we went to
on
a couple
you.
Precepts and showed you
easy.
What the Bible, what God calls the white man and his nation.
The devil.
Now go back to Psalms 137. Now that we got that established, Psalms 137 and verse 1.
The book of Psalms, chapter 137, verse 1.
Come on.
By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down. Yea, we wept.
So the rivers of Babylon are the shores of America where we was dropped off on slave ships. Jump down to verse 3.
Verse 3.
Come on.
For there
in North America, go ahead.
They that carried us away captive required of us a song.
So in North America, in the United States specifically, this is what they wanted from the slaves, from the captives. They required of us a song, right? Because that's one of the many talents, one of the many blessings that we possess that put us above them, right? That makes us special in comparison to everybody else. We have that talent, right? To sing, rap, sing, music, period, right?
Right.
So they required of us a song. Now, remember what we read in Leviticus 26. They that hate you shall reign over you. Do you think that the song that they're going to require you to sing going to be a song talking about, you know, just the dedication? No, it ain't going to be that type of song.
Right.
It's going to be some, go get it sexy, get it sexy.
Yeah.
Our people are stupid as hell.
You understand? That's one of the major things.
Come on now, dog.
That's required of us, by the way. That's why they will pay a damn hoochie rat off the street that ain't good for a damn thing. They will give her millions of dollars to get in front of a camera, shake her ass, and rap about her booty hole being brown.
This is affliction, brothers.
Licking period.
But why?
It's in the Bible.
Right. Oh, my
God. Now read on.
And they that wasted us.
They that destroyed us, come on.
Required of us mirth.
It required of us what?
Required of us mirth.
So outside of the music, you got the rest of entertainment, which involves comedy, acting, and so forth. That's what the mirth is. They required of us entertainment. make us laugh. And that comes via sitcoms, movies.
Right.
You understand? Skits, stand-up, all of that. No, what? That's why the white man pay us so much money to do those things. And you notice when we do those things, it's not any type of positive reinforcement for our people.
Hell,
it's always
profanity
and highlighting the evil stereotypes concerning our people, perpetuating that in our minds.
Right. You can't make
you understand. Why? Because it's of the enemy. That's what they required of us. All right? Did you finish that?
Saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion.
So now, like, as we said, we showed y'all the trailer, and that's what got a lot of the people in the outrage. But we gonna go back to the original good times, because a lot of people, the people in the world that don't even know no damn better, they really just looking at it like, hey, now, come on now. The old one was wholesome. You understand? You know, it wasn't all that. All that unnecessary rapping and drugs and all of that stuff. Come on now, y'all tripping.
Come on, man.
The root of the tree is evil.
Mm.
You understand? The very beginning of this thing was concocted by the same damn devil.
Right. Exactly.
You was going to say something?
I want to say, because you got to think about it. That was years ago. That mean that was times where we was, as a black people, was kind of together. So you can imagine, you think they're going to allow something good come out of that with a black family? You out of your mind. That's
hell
why we know
no.
It wasn't no different as what we see today.
All right, now give me that first image. So the creators of the original Good Times was originally, put them on the screen real quick, this Eric Monte right here. I believe I'm saying his name right. Eric Monte, go to the other one. And Mike Evans, the young man that he teamed up with, that he met to, you know what I'm saying, make it happen, or begin to. Now, give me the next person. So you might be thinking, oh, okay, two black men in the 70s. But here go the ultimate piece of the puzzle right here. Put him on the screen. Norman Lear.
Oh, my God.
Norman Lear. Now, he's obviously an Edomite, right?
Facts.
But let's read a little bit about him. Scroll down real quick. Give me to the right. All right. You see where it say known for sitcoms. One of the main sitcoms. Scroll down. One of the main sitcoms he known for. There you go. Good Times. But also the Jeffersons and Sanfords. And some notables in there, right? Now, let's read Early Life and Education. Watch this, y'all. Come on.
Norman Milton Lear was born on July 27, 1922 in New Haven, Connecticut, to Jeanette and Herman Lear, a traveling salesman. He had a younger sister, Claire Lear Brown. Lear grew up in a Jewish household.
In a what?
In a Jewish household.
Y'all see this, right? Now, We did a whole, was it a series or was it just a show? The Truth About Jews and Basketball.
I believe it was just that episode.
And also Satan's Hand in the Music Industry.
Right.
Whenever we dealing with stuff like sports, entertainment, music, acting, and we deal with the Edomites that are behind it, running the show, the people holding the puppet strings.
Right.
That's always in a Wikipedia.
Every time.
They grew up in a Jewish household of Jewish descent.
Emily.
You understand? And that soundbite is perfect because what does God call Jewish? What the world called Jewish today? Because we the real Jews.
Right.
Who is the damn Jewish in the earth biblically? What is their name? Amalek.
That's right. You understand?
Now give me that in Exodus chapter 17 about Amalek. This is what the Lord said. Now, remember, we set the premise. They that hate you shall reign over you, right? So when it comes to these things, these major things like television and such, you're not going to get a product to empower you, period. It is what it is. You understand? Unless it's IUIC TV. And you see how they shadow ban us. You see how they do us.
Facts.
You understand? So when it comes to the stuff on the forefront that's being pushed to our people's faces and in their ears by the white media is going to be a tool to get you to hate yourself and your people. It is what it is. And it goes back to this right here. Exodus 17, and I believe it's verse 16. Read that.
The book of Exodus, chapter 17 and verse 16. For he said, because the Lord have sworn that the Lord will have war with Amalek from generation to generation.
So this thing's spiritual. You understand? Right. That was the first nation to try to harm us when we came out of Egypt, when we was delivered. They were the first nation to have a problem with our salvation.
Right.
You understand? For real. So God said that these people will have a vendetta against the Lord and his people forever and ever and ever, from generation to generation. That's why they took our land. That's why they took our identity. And that's why they control Hollywood, where they control the people that have the most influence over our people. You understand? Mm-hmm. They are the synagogue of Satan. Right. They are the adversary in the earth. Right. You understand? So it makes perfect sense. Now, why did I pull that? What they got to do with normally? All right, okay. Play. Give me that first video. All right. Watch this, y'all.
Norman Lear is a racist, a hypocrite, a thief, and a liar.
This is a man named Eric Monte. He was one of the creators and writers of the Norman Lear show Good Times back in the 70s. He says Norman Lear never properly paid him for his work in creating the show, and that Lear has wrongfully claimed credit for creating a number of shows that were based on characters or ideas that Eric came up with.
I said, if you want somebody funny to own the junkyard, you need to hire Red Fox. And Norman Lear said, Red who? And Norman Lear said, no. This is a white show. 2 months later, he was doing Sanford and Son with Red Fox.
I've always thought it was a little odd that Norman Lear, this Jewish guy from New Haven, Connecticut, could single-handedly create every single groundbreaking television show featuring working-class black families in the 70s. But when I first heard that there was a black man who was accusing Norman Lear of poaching his ideas and not giving him the proper credit, I have to admit, I was a little skeptical.
I had to fight and argue with Norman Lear for 3 years to show a complete black family on television.
Eric Monte, who suffered with drug addiction, homelessness, and eventually lost everything he had, says Norman Lear stole his ideas for shows like Good Times, The Jeffersons, Sanford and Son, and claimed them as his own, cheating Monte out of creator credits and millions of dollars. Shit. But is there any veracity to this claim? I'm Dara Starr Tucker, and this is The Breakdown. I grew up with this Norman Lear mythology. The spiel was that he just somehow had a sense for what America was ready for and had enough knowledge of the black experience to create these shows that reflected our culture and that knocked down racial barriers. He has 5 Emmys, the National Medal of Arts.
Hold on. Y'all see this, right?
Man.
Y'all see this, right? So the black woman, all praise to the Most High, she's showing some sort of consciousness.
Right.
But and when I say consciousness, not talking about black power, none of that.
Hell no.
It's like it's a little accountability. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
It's a little accountability. Like, I was under this impression, but now I'm starting to see the truth of what it is concerning this particular situation. You understand? But they just show you the mindset of reminds you. These people, the so-called white man, enslaved you with us, right?
Right.
Raped you. You understand?
Right.
Beat you. Mm-hmm. All abused you, all of that.
Oh.
But when it come to him, you always give him the benefit of the doubt.
Right.
Nah, I doubt he stole any ideas from this crackhead homeless guy.
Come on,
this famous black guy.
Surely they
he got all these accolades and all of that. No. Surely he's just a white genius who just knows
black
what
people.
Black people want
right.
and how to properly portray black people and make sitcom hits. He just got it in him.
You don't find that suspicious.
He's God. So she's being straight up like that's how I thought.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So all praises for that. Go back a few seconds, cause we gotta pick this up. We gotta just to show you her frame or nothing. Go to like 110. All right, bro.
Here we go.
There you go. All right, come on.
and eventually lost everything he had, says Norman Lear stole his ideas for shows like Good Times, The Jeffersons, Sanford and Son, and claimed them as his own, cheating Monte out of creator credits and millions of dollars. But is there any veracity to this claim? I'm Dara Starr Tucker, and this is The Breakdown. I grew up
Play on.
This Norman Lear mythology. The spiel was that he just somehow had a sense for what America was ready for and had enough knowledge of the Black experience to create these shows that reflected our culture and that knocked down racial barriers. He has 5 Emmys, the National Medal of Arts, and the Kennedy Center honor. Surely there couldn't be any truth to the rumor that he was a thief. Eric Monte, who was born Kenneth Williams, grew up...
Think about it. How did he get here?
Right.
How is this man called America?
Right.
But that's the psyche. Surely this man is not a thief. That's his heritage.
That's what they do.
That's his genealogical, biological track record. You understand?
Right.
How could that be hard to believe?
Come on now,
get John 10 real quick about the thief. John,
are you serious?
So this is what the Lord said about Satan. But remember, the Lord said they were the synagogue of Satan. They, just like we the temple of God in the earth. We the vessels of the Most High God. They are the vessels of the spiritual demon Satan.
The devil.
They operate directly through them. You understand?
Thanks.
Come on, read that.
The book of John chapter 10 and verse 10.
Three.
The thief cometh not, but for to steal and to kill.
Hold on. Read again from the top.
The thief cometh not.
The thief come. This is the only reason why the white man will come to you.
Right.
This the only. Listen, he not pulling up. What they teach us about? Was it Plymouth Rock?
He came to.
With the pilgrims.
The pilgrims, right?
Mayflower, right. Whatever the hell. What they teach us? The white man pulled up on a boat. Said, hey, Indians.
They were naked.
Let's eat.
They didn't know
let's
nothing.
Eat together.
Cap.
Let's be friends.
Cap.
You understand? What did the Bible say? Read that again.
The thief cometh not.
The thief cometh not. The white man is only coming to your country or to your family, to your business meeting, whatever, to do what?
But for to steal.
Listen, you got something good? You got a good idea. You
it's
know
mine.
Majority of these Damn. Inventions our people came up with.
Yes.
But we don't got no generational wealth to reflect that.
Message.
You understand?
No credit at all.
We don't get no credit. You understand?
How?
Why? Because not only our labor, our land, et cetera, was stolen, but our good ideas, our inventions. The white man, the Bible said he framed Mr. Bala. Oh, you don't have a patent. It's mine now.
Yep. Damn.
You understand?
Damn.
He don't come but to do nothing but steal. What else?
And to kill. And to destroy.
To steal, kill, and destroy.
To this day.
So why the hell the black woman shocked? Like, oh, huh? A thief? Him? A white man?
Kid. Can't be.
Come on now,
surely
dog.
He just knows just about the black experience.
There's
even though he's Jewish. And
are you serious?
Like the complete opposite of us and know nothing about us, really. But he just has the black experience down packed. Right?
Get out. Bad.
Right?
Right.
Hell no. What the hell wrong with you? All right. Now, where we at? Go to the next timestamp. All right. So let's see how it played out dealing with good times.
Hey, Cal, I gotta make a point though, cause we just read this. He said he came to steal, kill, and destroy, because what he did to the black people was put crack cocaine in the neighborhoods. He destroyed the black families, like we saw in the clip with the Good Times cartoon episode where they were pulling the drugs, mm-hmm. the guns in the neighborhood. Right. That's what the white man came to do, to destroy black imagery. So how he do that? He plants certain things in the community. And we see that. We witness. The Bible just said it, and we witnessing that right now.
I'm glad you
think
said
God is
that.
Not going to hold so, you guilty for that?
Okay, steal the idea for one. But when he steal the idea, he put that demonic twist on it. Mm-hmm. Because your idea might have been an intention to uplift.
Right.
He going to steal the idea and put his evil intention to destroy. Because he coming back.
Right.
But
to destroy.
So, yes, he would take these excellent ideas and then turn around and use them as mechanisms against your people. Instruments of destruction.
Damn. He know who we are.
And we gonna prove all of that. You understand? But watch this.
Did hire Eric Monte to write for Good Times. Eric describes his time as a writer on the show as being very contentious because he and several members of the cast were in constant battles with white writers and with Norman Lear about the tone and the stereotypes that were depicted in the show.
I caught hell because Norman Lear was an incredible racist, but he didn't think so. And everything they wrote was stereotypic. They thought of black humor as, y'all's a boss, I was going to go down by the river. I'd fight them tooth and nail. They'd ignore me in the offices, take that y'all's stuff down to the cast. John Amos, Esther Rolle, and John Dubois would have a fit. I would give them what I had written. Norman Lear would reluctantly shoot it, put it on the air, and it became a big hit.
He says after the first season, he was demoted as a chastisement for his constant battles with Norman Lear, and the white writers were promoted in his place. They eventually fired John Amos by killing off his character for the same reason.
Damn, damn, damn!
After the second season of Good Times, Eric Monte got a deal to write the Cooley High movie, and he left Norman Lear's production company altogether. Eric's movie Cooley High was a breakout hit in 1975, and that prompted ABC head Michael Eisner to call him in to discuss creating a show based on his movie. That show eventually became What's Happening.
Now y'all see that, right? Hold on. So the white man, not the white man. The black man escapes the dragon one time. He escaped Norman Lear. Well, he get out of that situation, make Cooley High, big hit without the white man.
Right.
White man come in and say, hey, let's sit down. Now, the scriptures say the thief cometh not, but to steal, kill, and destroy.
Right.
Message.
So he's not coming to give you a better life for what you did with Cooley High.
Trust me,
but of course, we don't know no better. Mm-hmm. You understand? We struggling. We. And we still got the white Jesus on the
he's
brain.
He's different, right.
He's coming to save my soul. But no. Watch
hell
this.
Hell no.
Play on. Watch this. Come on.
Him in to discuss creating a show based on his movie. That show eventually became What's Happening. Eric wrote a pilot for the script and ABC accepted it. Because he had been burned so badly by Norman Lear, Eric fought for more control this time and wanted to put the show out through his own production company. ABC execs said that because he didn't have any producing experience, they would have to hire a couple of line producers to work with him. Eric Monte's agent, Bernie Weintraub, also repped writer-producers Saul Turtletaub and Bernie Ornstein. When he finally saw the production deal, it was listed under something called Toy Productions.
And I was like, who the hell is Toy Productions? Turtletaub and Ornstein had gone out and formed a company with Bud York and Norman Lear's partner. ABC had signed to do the show with that company, and my agent, Bernie Weintraub, had negotiated the deal all behind my back.
Damn! Y'all see that, right?
Damn.
This
devil.
Is affliction, brothers.
Weinstein sounds like a damn Jewish last name. So your damn agent stab you. Give me that in Sirach 12 real quick.
Bring it up.
12 and 13.
So he sits down with these white people. He negotiated a deal, or so he thinks. And he thinks his white agent is working on his behalf. Whole time, they doing a damn coup d'etat. They come up with a whole corporation based off your idea and finesse you at the whole deal.
Damn.
You understand?
Damn.
The one person that got your back that you think working in your favor is working with the enemy against you.
Oh, my God.
Read that real quick.
The book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 12 and verse 13. Who will pity a charmer that is bitten with a serpent?
Who would pity somebody that play with snakes? You understand?
Damn.
When they get bit by a snake, who gonna pity them? You should have been playing no damn snake. Hey, you see me running around here playing with snakes.
Like you a two-time loser.
You understand?
Damn.
I ain't walking around here playing with snakes, so why would you?
Hell no.
Read on.
Or any such as come nigh wild beasts.
Right, you get towed up by a damn lion. Why the hell was you walking around playing with lions?
Right.
Rest we don't play that. They don't belong in our same habitat.
Are you serious?
You understand?
Right.
But read on.
So one that goeth to a sinner.
One that goes to the white man for success, for help, and to expand my ideas and give me a bigger platform.
Come on now,
when
dog.
You go to him, read on.
And is defiled with him in his sins?
You get finessed. You get your ideas stole. You get cheated. You get robbed.
This is affliction, brothers.
Hey, it is what it is. Never trust your enemy. But like I said, I people, we know no better. All right, go back. Go back.
Writers Guild to try and get them to mediate the situation. They offered him the bare minimum, which was a huge insult. So he took the only step that he felt was left. He filed suit against all of them. ABC, CBS, Turteltaub, Ornstein, Yorkin, Weintraub, and Norman Lear.
Norman Lear came to me and he offered me $1 million for a settlement. And I said, for all those shows, no way. So the lawyers came to me and they said, look, take that money because you still have your suit against the networks and the others. But at least we'll get paid. So when the papers came down, all the defendants were listed. So I said, I didn't agree to this. They said, either you take this or we're walking off the case. I went all over Los Angeles.
Y'all see that, right?
Damn, they evil.
This is affliction, brothers.
You should have no power to stand against your enemies. We fit this Bible. We fit these curses. Now, notice it was about a minute back. It talked about the actors. He wasn't the only one fighting against what they was putting in the writing with the white people, all the stereotypes and all of that. He wasn't the only one fighting with the white writers, you understand, on the set.
The white man.
The father of the show, the father character, was fired. They tried to twist it and make it seem like it was something else, but he came out and was straight up, no, I got fired.
Oh, so my God.
Look at this story right there. Play that for us. Come on. Yeah, he was just right there.
Good times. As Good Times entered production, the intent was for the series to focus on the entire family, specifically the parental styles of James and Florida Evans. However, as the series hit the air, it was clear that Jimmy Walker's J.J. Evans had become the breakout character. As a result, the writers and producers began to make JJ the star of the show, much to the dismay of John Amos and Esther Rolle. As JJ's role in the series increased, the tone of the show started to become more broad, and it moved away from the series that was supposed to deal with serious topics in a comedic way. Amos's initial grips with the show included his character James Evans not being able to hold down a job and provide a decent income for his family. He also thought the character JJ could prove to be a dangerous role model for children due to the character's outrageous antics that catered to stereotypes. On the show, James and Florida had three children, JJ, Thelma, and Michael. The character Michael wanted to be a Supreme Court justice, while Thelma aspired to be a surgeon. As the show's popularity continued to grow, JJ quickly became a fan favorite among audiences. As a result, the show's storyline began to center more around him, leaving Thelma and Michael behind as supporting cast members. Amos felt that his other two children should have been used more and would have been a better role models for those watching. The writers would prefer to put a chicken hat on JJ and have him prance around saying, "Dynamite." In that way, they could waste a few minutes and not have to write meaningful dialogue. In 2020, Amos was interviewed by comedian Lunell on Vlad TV, where he detailed his disagreements with the writers. "I felt like I knew more about what a black family should be and how a black family should act than our writers, none of whom were black. Their perception or their idea of what a black family would be and what a black father would be was totally different from mine, and mine was steeped in reality." Amos went into further detail about the lack of black writers in a 2007 interview with Sway in the Morning. "The truth of it was, when the show first started, we had no African-American writers on the show. And some of the attitudes they had written, as per my character, and frankly for some of the other characters as well, caused me to say, we can't do this, we can't do that." According to Amos, the white writers were asked why not, and he responded, "Well, how long have you been black? That just doesn't happen in our community. We don't think that way, we don't act that way. We don't let our children do that." Amos admits that he wasn't very tactful when it came to his complaints with the scripts that were coming in. Arguments with the writers got so bad that they would sometimes end with Amos saying, "Well, let's go outside then," implying that he was going to fight them. Amos said that Hollywood writers weren't used to this type of confrontations. Eventually, Amos's outspokenness would cost him his job on Good Times. Mm. Amos has explained before that after the third season of Good Times, he received a call from Norman Lear, who told him he had good news and bad news. The good news is that Good Times was renewed for a fourth season. The bad news is that Amos's contract would not be picked up by the producers, meaning that he would not be returning for the fourth season.
Pause.
The fourth season.
So y'all see that, right? Give me Isaiah 29 real quick.
Bring it out.
So the brother thought, man, look, I'm a star in a stone chain. Don't with you. What you mess with the time for? All right, just relax.
Bring it out.
So I'm one of the main characters on the show. I'm the daddy. You know what I'm saying? I matter. I got to say so. I can voice my opinion. Right? Now read that Isaiah 29, 21. Come on.
The book of Isaiah chapter 29 and verse 21.
Yeah.
That make a man an offender for a word.
So they make a man an offender for a word. A right word. Go ahead.
And lay a snare for him that reproveth in the gate.
They lay a snare from him. They lay a snare for him that reproveth in the gate. What was the snare for him? Damn termination. You understand? Oh, this nigga want to tell us how to portray black people.
Right.
He has the audacity as a black man to tell white people how black people act.
What's wrong with him?
Nigga, we created you.
Damn.
We made you, nigga. Sit your black ass down. You understand?
Right.
They laid a snare for him because he was reproving them. Black people don't do, we don't teach our kid this and this. Nigga, are you? Do you not know what this programming is about? That's the goal. That's what this is about, stupid nigga. Now
you better shut your black lips.
Find your ass another job somewhere. You understand?
This is affliction, brothers.
The killer thing about this is right now, they won't. And this thing coming from poverty and how they inject us up mentally, majority of the time. At least when you start to get a little pushback, the black man that never had nothing and finally got, you know, a job as such, you an actor, you get some money or whatever. When you get to the point to where you get some pushback, you are just humble down. You say, well, you know what, man, it is what it is. You know, hell, this better than working at a fast food joint or a restaurant here. Yes, sir, master. Okay.
Right.
But majority of the time, it don't even take all that. It just, yes, sir, master, what you want me to do? What you want me to say? And we're going to show y'all, if y'all stick around, we're going to show y'all that that's how you got the good times cartoon. The voice actors. That's their attitude. Man, look, it's all about a check. I don't give a damn about none of that, man. We making money.
What?
You understand? So all praises to the Most High that he had that spirit to stand up and speak out and say something. You know what I'm saying? Even though it was a snare for him. All right, it is what it is. Go back to the video. You were finna say something?
No, so that go back to the Sirach 13 that we always bring out. The rich man, he threatening. And the poor man, he still got a... But, Master, the rich man done wrong, but at the end of the day, us as a nation, the blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, we get the bottom end of the stick every single time.
You can put... This
is our third video.
We got time. This is Friday Night Raw. You understand?
Get that real quick. Ecclesiastes chapter 13, start at verse 2.
The book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 13 and verse 2.
Come on.
Burden not thyself above thy power while thou livest. Burden not thyself above thy power while thou livest.
The Lord warned us. Don't burden yourself above your power while you live. Let's see what that burdening is. Come on.
And have no fellowship with one that is mightier and richer than thyself.
Yes, here it is. We have one. We have a black actor coming at the writers and producers of the show that's paying him. God says, no, y'all are not fellows together. Come on.
For how agree the kettle and the earthen pot together?
Uh-huh.
For if the one be smitten against the other... It shall be broken.
Come on.
The rich man have done wrong, and yet he threateneth with all.
This is why you can't have fellowship with one that is richer than you or more powerful than you. Like the brother made the mistake with doing. He thought that he was on the same playing field as the Lear man, and he wasn't. Read that again.
The rich man have done wrong.
Uh-huh.
And yet, he threateneth with all.
Understand the power that the execs have, the producers have, the main people over the Amalekite rulers of the entertainment industry, their power is here, and the actors are down here.
the rappers are down here. But sometimes they get the idea that they're on the same playing field, and they got to give you your Negro wake-up call. Come on.
The poor is wronged, and he must entreat also.
Here it is. The poor is wronged. They're giving you lines that don't line up with your ways or how you want to be represented, but you still got to entreat him like, can we not write this? Can we not do that? And that rich man still has power over you. Come on.
If thou be for his profit, he will use thee.
Uh-huh. Damn.
But
hold on.
Oh, my
hold
God.
On. Hold it. Hold it.
Hold
it. There's some butter there.
Hold up.
The Bible says, if you be for his profit, talking about the rich man,
talking about the white man.
Right. If thou be for his profit, let's start there. What is his profit? What does he profit from? Our destruction.
Exactly.
Our loss is his profit.
Exactly. Damn.
Us losing more father figures in the household. Us losing more men with a backbone that has set their house in order. Us losing that drive to get careers and take care of our families and right. so on and so forth. That is detrimental to his society. But to see us, you know, be destroyed, be broke, be lazy,
right?
Just be funny, shucking jive. Ain't that what was right. the good times?
Yep.
Quote, shucking jive.
Mm-hmm. Shucking jive.
That's for his profit. And that's what makes people laugh. That's yep. entertainment. So if thou be for his profit, meaning you're for that, you, oh, hey, yeah, master, I got you. Right?
Yeah,
he will what?
He will use.
He you. Will use your black ass.
Come on now, dog.
You'll get your damn contract.
Right.
Yeah. Come on.
But if thou have nothing,
uh-huh.
he will forsake thee.
But if you want to take a stand and you don't want a second jive, he'll send you on about your way.
Got good news and I got bad news.
Damn.
You must have forgot what you was here for, Negro. I need you here to coon and buffoon and destroy your people.
You,
you don't want to do that
your
no
black
more.
Lips.
I'm done with you.
You can't make this stuff up.
Video.
Play.
Fourth season. The fourth season of Good Times would debut in September 1976, and the season opened up with the news that James Evans was killed in a car accident, confirming the loss of Amos as a cast member.
Kill
in
the
1976,
nigga.
A Jet magazine reporter asked Amos about his departure from the series, and he simply responded, "I was fired." Earlier reports stated that Amos leaving Good Times had to do with his desire for a movie career. But after more investigation, it was most likely had to do with Amos's and Lear's constant disagreements over the direction of the show. Amos even revealed how difficult it was for him to lose his job during this period. "It was a bad thing for me because I had two kids in college at the time. We did have some very strong creative differences as to how James Evans should be portrayed and the part that the children would play in the show." Amos's absence was felt among the cast, crew, and viewers. One fan on the show wrote to Jet magazine to express her displeasure. "Dear editor, I was most distressed after reading in your May 13 issue that John Amos would no longer be a part of Good Times. I feel that John Amos provides a spark that cannot be rekindled. If possible, I hope that those responsible will reconsider the decision to write him out of the script." Margaret Holt, Jackson, Mississippi. James Evans was one of the TV's strongest black fathers. Aside from James at the time, there was only George Jefferson and Fred Sanford to look at. However, James was the only one married and supporting three kids.
Damn.
John Amos was very aware of the message he wanted to get across when it came to Good Times. A close, tight-knit, hard-working black family was something that America hadn't seen yet. Good Times would eventually set the precedent for black sitcoms that would come
That's it. Y'all see that, right? So out of the three black men on television at the time, he was the only one that was married and provided for his family.
Mm.
And they killed the nigga in the car wreck. Got him off the show.
You can't make this
that
stuff
easy.
Up.
This is affliction, brothers.
Alrighty. So, now, it's another video. I might have didn't send it.
Bring it out!
I guess I can send it. We got time. So, well, they kind of hit on it in his video. So, basically, the woman, the actor, her character name Florida Evans, Esther, her name Esther something. She didn't agree with it either, But of course, you know, they paid her whatever, so she kept, you know, she kept going on the seasons or whatever. Blah, blah, blah. But in hindsight, right, because I seen this some years ago. Mind you, I never watched the show, but years ago I seen a post that was breaking down, like, how black people look back on her like she was, you know, the black mama of TV. And, you know, yeah, she was a good mama and all of that, but she was actually the villain of the show.
Damn!
And mind you, we just showed you the daddy person, the character, he got cut off from the show for speaking out against it. The black writers was cut off from the show. She was finna get cut off from the show too. You understand? But then they made her, you know, the star again or whatever, gave her what she wanted for a time. But eventually the show fell off.
Damn!
But when she was the star of the show and all of that, blah, 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 she was actually the villain of the show the whole time. And it's people that's in hindsight that's looking back and they breaking it down. All right, play that video. And it's, and we not saying this ain't no shot to her. She was just the actor, the actress that agreed to play the roles for the money.
Message.
But Amalek that was behind it, Norman Lear, you understand? This right. is what they, you know, this is what they wanted. This is how they wanted to portray the black woman, the black mother. Play that. Come on. Unmute to the far right.
The TV show villain and the actual villain. The TV show. Now, the show Good Times had a lot of villains over the years. You had Penny's mom, who was burning her with the iron, had the fake preacher, had their cousins who tried to rob them, a whole bunch of other people tried to rob them. But the biggest villain of all is this one here. Florida Evans might have been the worst TV mom on the planet. Before I get started on this rant, have you guys ever really paid attention to the theme song of Good Times? Because they're talking about Good Times, but there's not shit about that song that's good. Temporary layoffs, easy credit ripoffs, scratching and surviving, hanging in a child line. What the fuck about that is good?
Pause.
They should have called.
Give me Deuteronomy 28:37. So, they call it Good Times because we had to make the best out of the shittiest situation in America.
Right.
And after so many years of slavery, free slave labor, sun up to sun down, working, breaking your damn back, when you get a temporary layoff, you lose your job, but you get a little, you know, little unemployment pension or whatever, it's woo!
Come
you
on
know what
now,
I'm saying?
Dog.
You get an easy credit ripoff, like the damn PPP loan today.
Right.
Hell, that was the highlight of COVID for black people.
Come
you understand?
On,
that is good times for niggas.
Hell no.
Because we don't got it good in America. Right. Read that. Watch this.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 37.
Come on.
And thou shalt become an astonishment.
Thou shalt become a what?
An astonishment.
An astonishment. Yes, it is absolutely astonishing that we would call such things good times. But God said that was going to happen to us, y'all. God said we was going to become an astonishment.
Right.
It is what it is. And that's the thing about it. You know, hey, at the end of the day, all this stuff is, you can't do nothing against the Lord. Right. This stuff is further proof that we are God's chosen people according to Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter.
That's right.
It is what it is. God said we will become an astonishment. Come on.
A proverb.
A what?
A proverb.
A proverb, meaning a wise saying. And it's so wise that they put it in a theme song that they knew all black people would relate to. You understand? Easy credit ripoffs, temporary layoffs. What's the, when we pull this scripture, what do we say about black people? First, what is, last hire.
First
fire.
Damn.
Oh, yeah, they're going to relate to that. Yeah, make the daddy to where it's hard for him to get a job, keep a job. The lazy-ass 18-year-old nigga that want to stay up under mama, don't want to get a job and all that, want to complain and just be funny and second job. Yeah. Proverb. Why sin?
Right. Damn.
That's what we just read. That's a curse. Good times was curse times.
Damn.
Read.
And a byword.
And a byword, being called names outside of your God-given name. Go ahead.
Among all nations, whither the Lord shall lead thee.
So now, go back. Go back to the clip. So he finna break it down, dealing with mama on the show. All right?
Damn it. Now back to the rant. Florida Evans was by far the worst television mom in black TV history because she kept that family broke, struggling, and in the ghetto. Every time something good came into the lives of the Evans family, this bitch would find a way to fuck it up. Y'all remember that episode when James found
hey,
like 20...
Pause it. Hey, and listen, that's how they want the black woman to be. That is, we used the clip earlier. And Let's Talk Truth radio show, we went over wars in heaven and earth. Because I know people might be thinking, damn, all this stuff going on, they want to talk about a TV show. Damn it, we talked about the wars earlier. subscribe to the show. Let's Talk Truth. All right, all praise to the Most High God. Shout out to all the other mighty radio shows of IUIC that have covered all of this marvelous prophecy coming to pass. All praise to the Most High.
That's right.
But earlier on the show, earlier today, we brought out a clip of this dude named Smart. And he said that the most valuable soldier in a white man's army is the black woman.
Damn.
This show, they cultivated, they... This
mastermind
was,
that thing,
you understand
sure.
How they molded the image of a black mother at that time. What do we want you to do? How do we want you to behave? How do we want you to act and interact with your children in your household when your husband got ideas or when he want to do this or do that? You are trained to talk back and shut shit down. And just her alone, her role on that TV screen gave black woman more audacity to talk back to their husband.
Wow. Oh, my God!
That's what the TV show gave power to the black woman in the black household. Mm-hmm. We ain't got to do that. I got the last say so. And that's, guess what? That's how we was raised as kids.
Yep, right.
Especially with grandma, who was doing her time, right for me, right? Grandma was doing her time. You understand? So, no, she got the last say so when it come to this, come to that. I couldn't go to Pawpaw for the no final okay.
What?
You understand?
That's your grandma.
And that trickled down to my mama. That's the cycle. No. Listen, read what you got. Proverbs 14:1. Did I call it out? Damn.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 14 and verse 1.
This is, what's her name? Florida Evans. Mm-hmm. Read.
Every wise woman buildeth her house.
So a wise woman going to build her house. A wise woman going to do what it take to get her family out the ghetto in a better situation under the leadership of her husband.
Message.
That's what a wise woman would do. Go ahead.
But the foolish plucketh it
down.
But
the foolish Florida Evans created by Norman Lear, Amalek, the white man, would do what?
But the foolish plucketh it down.
The foolish
with
will keep her family in a Cabrini Green project.
Oh my God!
Section 8. Poor. You understand? That's what a foolish woman gonna do. And a lot of the black women, they gravitated to that. They found themselves becoming what they were seeing on TV for 7 years straight.
Right. Don't fall for it.
Hey, you just made me think of that episode where the young brother, her son, came to her. He was talking about Christ is black. And she was like, no, not my Jesus.
No, my Jesus is
she
white.
Plucked every thought frame out of his head on that thing. And
damn.
This is what they do. Yep. You grow up, no, I know Jesus is white. Look at this picture. This picture proves it.
Yep.
Shut your mouth.
That's the next
every
clip.
Time he.
That's the next.
I'll praise it. I'll praise it.
Do you got the clip about when he wanted to? When he was talking about he wanted to be work for the Supreme Justice and stuff like that.
I got a clip. I wasn't able to hear that. I don't know. Let's see. And if we don't, then we'll find it. All right. Did we play? We got to play the rest of that clip. Play the rest of that.
20, $30,000 and something, and Florida Evans convinced him to give it back. Are you out your damn mind?
I seen it.
James, it ain't right to be taking money that don't belong to us. All I know is it may not be right to be taking money that don't belong to me, but I do know if I ever find $27,000 anywhere, I'm keeping that shit. Y'all remember when she fucked up that damn commercial? Y'all remember when she messed up that ketchup commercial? James, they got me telling lies! I haven't used this product, the ketchup! Bitch, it's a commercial! Everybody lies! It's called advertising! Do you really think OJ in the 70s was running through Hertz fucking rental cars? Do y'all remember that time that JJ posted a picture of Black Jesus and everything in the family started to brighten up? Like Michael got $5, James got promoted, and somebody, like a whole bunch of other things started happening, and she didn't want it because she just wanted her good old-fashioned white Jesus hanging up there?
What?
I'm like, the white Jesus is probably why you catching so much hell.
Right. Damn! Now.
Sheesh.
Hey.
Whoa, my God.
Jesus.
Hey, we gotta play that back.
Run it back.
Play it again.
Wise words from the fear, man.
Play it again.
Good old-fashioned. And somebody, like, a whole bunch of other things started happening, and she didn't want it because she just wanted
her. Go back. When you said they put the black image up and it was good stuff happening for them. Come on, man.
Hey, just go back some more, brothers. Come on.
Not to last week. I go to like 145, brothers. Sheesh. I wish I could just turn off my arm and throw it over there. There we go.
Do y'all remember that time that JJ posted a picture of Black Jesus and everything in the family started to brighten up? Like Michael got $5, James got promoted, and somebody, like a whole bunch of other things started happening, and she didn't want it because she just wanted her good old-fashioned white Jesus hanging up there? I'm like, the white Jesus is probably why you catching so much hell right now living in the ghetto, and somebody takes a picture of Black Jesus and things turn around and you got a problem with it? This ain't the right Jesus, James! Put her back in the closet! Really, she kept that family content with being broke and struggling, using white Jesus to do it. Because that was her thing.
Oh my God!
Can't make this up. And that's the black woman.
That's the scripture.
They normally created. I'm telling the white man, the inward thought of every one of them. Can we get that real quick?
Psalms
chapter 64, verse 6. He knew what he was doing with Florida Evans, bruh.
Right.
He knew what he was doing. That's why he fired all the niggas that had a problem with it. You niggas are not going to stop me. For real,
you better shut up, black lips.
Get the hell out of here.
This is affliction, brothers.
The book of Psalms, chapter 64, verse 6.
Come on.
They search out iniquities.
They do what?
They search out iniquities.
So this is what the white man does. They search out ways to keep us in sin.
Right.
What can I do to turn the woman against the husband and the mama against the daughter and the son against the father, so on and so forth. They search out strategies on how to make these enterprises a success.
Come on now.
Come on.
They accomplish a diligent search.
They do what?
They accomplish a diligent search.
Y'all know that it's actually like research done. You know what's funny, right? I'm in college right now. I'll pray to the Most High. I'm in college. So I'm studying psychology. So in psychology, you gotta, like, really what it's all about is studying, researching research that has been done, that has been conducted by scientists who've analyzed people's brains and behaviors via experiments. And a white man got literally countless libraries full of books just from them experimenting on our brains and behaviors based off scenarios. Oh, your mother's on crack. Your father left. You understand?
Right. Oh, my God.
It's library. And you ain't never went to a library and been sat down and read a book with that information. Who does?
Hell no.
Him.
Right.
Hollywood.
The devil.
You understand? They search these things out with a diligent search. Come on.
Both the inward thoughts of every one of them and the heart is deep.
Meaning they think light years ahead. They think many generations. That's why that character, Florida Evans, had a generational impact.
Mm-hmm.
they weren't just thinking about a little trend to have people doing something for a couple of years. No, this is what I want the black mother to become.
Right.
Somebody that keeps her family, her who strives to continue to raise her children with me in control, giving her housing, giving her
y'all better take heed to that.
On me and removing the black man out of the household. You understand?
You can't make
and
this
look,
stuff up.
Look, 50 years later, look at us. You understand? Very, very, very deep. Very deep. All right? Don't make me turn on my Uganda, man. My Uganda accent that I...
Come on now, dog.
You know what I'm saying?
Come on, man.
Very deep. All right. Go back to the finish that clip. Come on.
Struggling, using white Jesus to do it. Because that was her thing. And long we got the Lord, we hungry and struggling and can't pay our bills. And we almost get evicted in the first episode, but we got the Lord.
Hey.
My children.
Damn, finish it out. Because we ain't going to fix it. I don't want him to change points, though. If I feel like he's changing points, we're going to pause it. Put the mouse on the pause button. Go ahead.
Where we get beat up and mugged and almost sexually assaulted, but we got the Lord! The Lord! She was so terrible that James had to fake his death and move to Mississippi and start over and abandon all three of his kids. Y'all remember that episode I'm talking about, right? Damn, damn, damn! In conclusion, Florida heaven sucked. That is all.
All right, so give me Isaiah 30 and 12 about white Jesus. She put white Jesus over her husband to the point that the husband, according to him, I didn't know about that episode. He faked his death.
Damn.
They killed him off the show. He got fired, but they threw the narrative in down the line that what he really did was
fake his death. Damn.
Fake his death. When have you known a black man to fake his death? Except for allegedly Tupac. Right.
Come on now,
dog. Machiavelli, ain't it?
You don't find that suspicious?
Hey, but that's what the scriptures say. You would rather dwell in a wilderness than to dwell with a damn contentious woman.
Oh!
They said he faked his death. Started a whole new life in Mississippi.
The poor
way.
He went to a poor
wow. Ain't no way, boy.
Oh my God. Now read what you got.
The book of Isaiah
30 and 12.
Isaiah chapter 30 and verse 12.
Uh-huh.
Wherefore thus saith the Holy One of Israel.
Read.
Because he despised this word.
Despised the word. But she despised, we're gonna show it. She despised Revelation 1 for sure. Go ahead.
And trust in oppression.
And trust in what?
And trust in oppression.
And trust in oppression. That oppression that she trusted in was the welfare, the Section 8. The government, the white man taking care of her in white Jesus. White Jesus is oppression. You know what they used? You know what they taught us when they raped you, when they murdered us, broke us, slaved us, put us to work day in, day out without giving us a penny? You know what they taught us and indoctrinated us with and told us whose face they used to voice the message of slave obey your master? You know who they use to do that? White Jesus!
Right.
White Jesus is an embodiment of our oppression. Black woman trusted him. You know what's crazy? And I love my grandma to death. But that's my grandma. That's my grandma right there.
Not my Jesus.
All hell break loose. All her siblings and her husband and died and all this stuff going on. But she puts all her trust in white Jesus. You understand?
Oh, my gosh.
She
casts her burden on white. She casts her burden on white Jesus. For real. To this day.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? And read on. And what?
And perverseness.
And perverseness, because that's perverse as hell.
Right.
Get what you got to do to believe in him. You got to pervert the damn scripture. Well, I know it say white like wool, but I'm going to just use that for his skin, because see, his skin white. That ain't like wool, but it's white.
You see?
Now, his hair, I don't know. I mean, Surely, what they say on Book of Clarence? They said, now mind you, they was Israelites in the movie. They was living in Jerusalem. Right. They actually knew Jesus, walked among Jesus. But when they saw, when they cleaned up the dirty, stinking ass white man, they said, he looks like Jesus.
Oh my God!
What?
What are you talking about? Huh?
His aura, his just, wow. It just looks like God. Perverseness. Somebody with no melanin who the sun hurts. The sun hurts you, but you got.
Right. I need you to shut the hell up.
You understand? Your hair fall to the ground. It smells very badly when it gets wet. Oh. But you're a God, though.
You get lice.
Hell no.
Man.
Like you said, though, Cap, that's that other gospel. That's another spirit.
Another spirit.
It's that aura. Old. And that same spirit comes with feminism and the black woman being oppressive to her husband in the household.
You can't all right. make this
now
stuff
give
up.
Me the give me the famous clip. All right. Give me the famous clip right here.
Mama, couldn't we at least let black Jesus hang alongside?
Forget it. The only Jesus I know is him. And the one thing he don't need is a partner.
Mama, how do we know Jesus wasn't black? He could have been from the lost tribe of Israel. They were supposed to be black.
I bet they were. If ever people were lost, we're it.
Now just hush up, both of you. This picture has been in my family for as long as I can remember.
Hold on. Amalek wrote it. Amalek made this.
Man.
You don't find that suspicious?
That? He gonna pull the scripture too. He said that the lost tribes of Israel, they supposed to be black. And the damn goofball, he said, yeah, if anybody lost, it damn sure on us.
Right.
What's
that?
Broke clock right twice a day.
Yeah, wow. They gonna pull the scripture too.
I know, but I'm just saying, like, you just got it. The white man wrote that.
Yep. Mocking us.
Hey, the white man. Because remember, in 1969, so this is 1972, right, when this came. So we know when this show started. So we know what they were doing. They seen prophets on the streets teaching that God is black, Christ is black. So, well, you know, we know Negroes gonna watch this show. Let's get these niggas. Let's put this in here and say, no, Jesus is white.
Come shut on, man.
We see that hatred right there.
Are you serious?
Esau, put it out there for us, man.
Crazy.
That's crazy. Bold.
You can't go make back. This stuff
I saw first. My mama, my papa, or this Jesus. Now, he's the one I know and love. So let's close the subject.
Pause it. Hey, that's the same thing that nigga Charleston White said. Y'all remember that?
I remember.
That's the same exact thing Charleston White said.
He said, watching
my mama and my granny, nigga, they always saw the white Jesus, nigga, that's the God I'm going to serve.
Yeah, for real.
Find me that clip. Somebody help me out in the chat.
Come on, man.
Find me that clip. Charlie White said the same thing as Florida Evans. You can't make this up.
Damn.
You cannot make this up, man.
I will embarrass you.
But go back, though. Play, keep playing. It's more to it.
When I was a baby, I don't know what I saw first. My mama, my papa, or this Jesus. Now, he's the one I know and love. So let's close the subject.
Jesus was black. The Bible would have said so.
But it does say so.
Huh? What are you talking about?
I read about it. It's in Revelations chapter 1, verse 14. I read about it in Muhammad Speaks. It says, his hair is like wool, and his eyes are like flame of fire.
Well, Lord, have mercy. You sure do say that, don't it?
And see, Mama, look at her hair, like wool, ain't it? And look at them eyes, red like fire.
Yeah, they sure is. Junior, how come you decided to paint this?
I don't know. All of a sudden, I just had divine thoughts on my mind.
And for JJ, that's a first.
What, having divine thoughts?
No, having a mind.
I guess I ought to be grateful for JJ having Jesus on his mind in any color.
Then we can hang him on the wall, Mama?
Well, now, I...
Please, Mama.
All right. But just for Black History Week, after that, he comes down.
Wow.
You see that?
Wow.
Oh, my
see
God.
That? She oh know. God. That's how the black woman is today.
So, hold on. So, he read the scripture, and she didn't. She couldn't refute it?
Nope.
Well, damn.
Well, I'll be damned.
But the nigga still got to come down after the week.
Damn.
Whoa.
That's a powerful nigga tree.
That's a powerful nigga tree at work.
It's a black week.
Jeez. 1 week. The nigga got to come down even though he fit the Bible.
You know what's crazy? The Edomites, they slick, man. They didn't finish the scripture, though.
Right,
the bird like friend.
Oh, no, we gotta stop. Okay.
You're right, you're right. Red eyes. You do say that. Okay.
Damn.
Damn.
Hey, you shit. Notice? Did you say Black History Week?
Yeah.
Week. So we didn't even have a full month yet. It's 1972. We
didn't. Have- Damn.
Alright.
Damn.
Give me the next clip. So she did some old cooning too. I don't know if this is the clip you're speaking about, but it's one of. That ain't it. Hold on, brothers.
Hey, can I get a script real quick?
Go ahead.
Hey, Lamentations 4 and 17.
It's a Facebook link.
It's the issue we have. And just like what, Amalek had pushed on the airways
Amalek.
With good times to deceive our people and thinking another. Remember, we just read in John 10 that all they come to do is to kill, destroy, and rob us and right. steal from us, right? So watch what the Bible says. Read that.
The book of Lamentations, chapter 4, and verse 17.
Come on.
As for us, our eyes as yet failed for our vain help.
Our eyes have failed for our vain help. Read on.
And our watching.
Uh-huh.
We have watched for a nation.
We what?
We have watched for a nation.
Uh-huh.
That could not save us.
We go after nations that cannot save us. His whole purpose on earth is to destroy us.
Right.
But we want to go after him. That's vain help. We have been deceived, and it's because what they push on their ways. We accept him as our savior, when in reality, they're here to destroy us.
Yeah. Hey, this thing will make it be his phone. It's the Facebook link, brothers, that was after the Jesus clip.
Think God is not going to hold you guilty for that?
Facebook link, brothers. Okay. Oh, God. It's under the Good Times Black Jesus on the IT page. That's the one? Okay. Damn, my fault. Lord have mercy. I repent. Sheesh.
You want the Charleston White thing real quick?
Yeah, somebody found it?
Yeah, it looked like he found it.
Yeah, pull it up. Can you go back to what she said so we can match them up real quick? Go back to what she said.
Not my Jesus.
Is that gonna be too hard for you, brothers?
Come on now, dog.
Right there.
All right.
Baby, I don't know what I saw first. My mama, my papa, go or back, this go Jesus. Back,
now, like 25. Baby, go back like 25.
Not just hush up, both of you. This picture has been in my family for as long as I can remember. When I was a baby, I don't know what I saw first. My mama, my papa, or this Jesus. Now, he's the one I know and love, so let's close the subject.
Jesus was black. The Bible would have said so.
All right, now play the Charleston White clip. My mama, my grandma, my nana.
Yeah, good.
Say, all you Yahweh talking motherfuckers, get your motherfucking ass up out of here. Fuck that Yahweh shit. Yeah, we can't even spell Yahweh. Yeah, don't come in here with that bullshit. This is the Jesus loving, white boy, blonde hair, blue eye loving Jesus channel. Don't bring your motherfucking ass with that nigga shit. Now black motherfucking God ain't free now motherfucking. That Hebrew talking shit you niggas talking ain't got us out of nothing. Nigga, white Jesus got me out of jail. Mama was down there praying to white Jesus. Mama brought white Jesus to me, and that got me free. I don't want to believe in no nigga ain't never got a nigga free. Fuck what? You talking about. Nigga, fuck, if we got a nigga, if this is a nigga Jesus, we in trouble. I'm saying it right now.
Charleston White is not a real person.
Oh, he is a
clone.
God.
He's a clone.
He's a clone. They cloned him.
Reptilian.
Dummy.
Sheesh. Hey, give me 2 Maccabees 4, verse 15. Read it.
2 Maccabees chapter 4 and verse 15.
Go ahead.
Not setting by the honors of their fathers.
So we didn't want to agree with Revelation chapter 1 on good times.
Right.
We didn't want to agree with that. That damn. Or the prophets, the Son of God, etc. in the Bible. Go ahead.
But lacking the glory of the Grecians, best of all.
But this white Jesus is who I've been serving my whole life.
Oh, my God!
My whole life has led to me being in a project, struggling, broken, oppressed. But this is my God that got me here, and I love him.
Hold
white
up.
Jesus.
Hold up.
Go ahead.
By reason whereof, so a calamity came upon them.
You see that? You see how the Bible works?
Right.
So you want to serve the white man. That's why your ass going through it. That was what calamity is upon our people. Read on.
For they had them to be their enemies.
They had them, the enemy, to be their enemies and what else?
And avengers.
And hero.
And savior. And Messiah.
How?
What the hell is this?
How?
That is a paradox. Is that the proper word? That's a paradox, ain't it?
Zach, right.
Zach. Hey, can I get someone there real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
Hey, just back to the thought, though, real quick. Because the dude said in the video that we watched where he was like, how the hell, that's you serving a white Jesus. That's why you going through stuff in the skit, remember?
Right.
So you just read the proof right there showing you can't do that.
Yes.
You can't serve a white Jesus and think you're going to be saved or have good success. You destroying yourself.
Hell no.
Mention church, they still don't get that. Get that in Zechariah chapter 7, verse 11 and 12.
Freedom.
It's the Christian church all day. Christians, we deal with it at camp all the time. Oh, I love God. I love God. Read the scripture. We read the scripture. Now they rethinking everything. No, not my Jesus, but then Jesus, the Jesus, same Jesus. No, what Bible y'all reading from? They refuse to hear the words of God. Read what you got.
Zechariah chapter 7, verse 11.
Uh-huh.
But they refused to hearken and poured away the shoulder and stopped their ears.
It's the la, no, Michael, this the only Jesus I know. I don't know who I seen first, mama, papa, or white Jesus. Come on.
That they should not hear. Yay. They made their hearts as an adamant stone.
Our people make their hearts as adamant stones. They do not want to hear the words of God. Charleston White, y'all can stop with that Yahweh stuff. Ain't no black man. He's making his heart adamant as a stone. Come on.
Lest they should hear the law
and
the words which the Lord of hosts have sent in his
because
spirit.
Because they know at the end of the day, if they confirm that Jesus is black, God is black, the Israelites are black, then we must keep the commandments of God. Charleston White don't want to keep no commandments. So his scapegoat is to deny everything the Bible says or everything that the truth represents.
Well done.
All righty. Let's go to the next clip, man. See what else Conan she did. Don't worry about them damn ugly ass feet.
I thought you wanted to go to Carolyn to be a lawyer.
I do. Mama, someday I'm going to sit on a Supreme Court.
If your father catches you here, you ain't going to be able to sit anywhere. Honey, in Washington's time, lots of people owned slaves. You got no call to be disrespectful to George Washington because he owned slaves. He's a great man. He was our first president.
Wow.
Her son. Because I watched this episode. He got suspended from school for speaking out against George. He's telling his mom, like, Mama, we was revolutionary. We was this, we was that. And George Washington, look at nothing but a slave owner. He got suspended for that, and his family was about to torture him for that thing. His daddy, mama, they was about to kill him for that thing.
Damn!
This got to be one of the worst scenes that she ever did.
This is like coonery buffoonery to a whole nother level.
Jeez.
You see what I'm saying? Like,
you can't make this stuff up.
I'm telling you, man, that brother was right about her character, bro. And I used to watch Good Times, bro. She always was cool.
The worst mom.
Man.
Mm.
Damn. So
what he earned slaves? He was a great man.
How?
Sway?
How?
They had to pay her triple amount to do that scene, man.
It would have, as a black person, it would have been no amount of money that you should take to act it out. That's why they had to get rid of Jane. That's why they had to get rid of Jane, because coonery like that, he wasn't going for that stuff, man.
That is powerful niggardry at work.
Even in that episode, because I said they was going to get on to him, whenever James actually sat down with the boy in the room, he was like, boy, I oughta. And the son started explaining to him everything that he was learning. He was like, well, you right. I can't whoop you for wanting to be revolutionary, for wanting to take a stand for your people. Mm. But the mama expected the daddy to go in a room and tear his tail up, but he didn't do it.
That's why the scripture said, like, he pulled the Psalm 64 and 6. The white man, his thoughts are deep. He knew he was training a black woman way from back then. We're going to train these women to go against their husband. You know what I'm saying? His thoughts is deep. You know what I'm saying? That's why the scripture said we battle against principalities. You know what I'm saying? We battle not against flesh and blood. And if we're not teaching our kids and we're not raising our people up according to thus said the Lord, they're going to fall victim to stuff, to coonery just like this.
To this day.
To this day.
Hey, get Proverbs 28 and 4. So this is her character, not her as a person. She was hired, right? And Amalek wrote the role. You know, you know how to, hey, you know how people play their roles so good. You will hate that individual for life.
Yeah, you're right.
For real, it wasn't her, y'all. It was the role that Amalek wrote for her. Proverbs 28 and 4.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 4.
One, two.
They that forsake the law praise the wicked.
They do what?
They that forsake the law praise the wicked.
Praise the damn wicked. She praised George Washington. He was a great man. So what? He raped my grandma.
Wow.
So what? He beat my father. So what? He stole my child and sold him away. So what? He was our first president. He was a great man.
Come on now, dog.
They that forsake the law praise the wicked. Do it.
But such as keep the law.
When you get the understanding of this Bible, when the scales come off your eyes, read.
Contend with them.
That's why we rebuke people like her. You understand? That's that have been duped and bamboozled by white supremacy. That's what we in the business in, contending with them. That's what we do on a day-to-day basis. Because our people are that damn destroyed to the point where they praise the wicked. They inadvertently worship the damn devil.
Right.
They had her on there as a damn devil worshiper.
Damn.
You understand?
She simplified you.
For real. All right. Now, what's next? Give me the, let me see. The video about the family. So we dealt with, so this is all just the former good times, just going into the background. So the families that were the true brains behind it, the idea before it was stolen and took over by Norman Lear, these two families, this is how they feel about the new good times, the cartoon. Play it.
Would be an issue compared to the show's original format, as it appears that the show's integrity and intention from creators Eric Monte and Mike Evans may get lost pushing narratives that reinforces negative stereotypes about black people. Now, in an exclusive statement given to Comedy Hype, the Monte and Evans families have announced that they aren't affiliated with the new series and are not approving of or blessing the new project. The families of Eric Monte and Mike Evans do not support nor have granted permission for the animated reboot of Good Times. From the looks of it, it appears that Norman Lear, before his passing, would move forward on the concept without Monte's and Evans' consent. And despite the ongoing reports that the original Good Times was stolen by him from Eric Monte and co-creator Mike Evans.
Pause.
So
the white man had to pull one last jack move before he died. He set the cartoon in motion without their consent again.
Hold up.
Damn.
After lawsuits and all of that, he went ahead and said, shit, I'm about to die anyway.
Somebody else's problem.
I don't got time to consult with you damn niggas.
Man.
And pushed it through again before he passed away.
Damn.
You can't make this up. That's why the scriptures say, as iron rusteth, so is his wickedness. It's like a damn, in the looking glass, you'll wipe it and you'll see it ain't went nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Despite the ongoing reports that the original Good Times was stolen by him from Eric Monte and co-creator Mike Evans, those in the YouTubeverse have learned in recent times that Lear looks to have taken majority of the credit and financial reward of a series he did not create. One of the main concerns from the families is that Eric Monte and Mike Evans' work stood for black empowerment and positive black imagery, and that this new project looks to not depict positive black imagery, as the men weren't there to make money, but to make history. They also took strong issue with some of the early press coverage that would mention Eric Monte and Mike Evans.
Pause it. So I'm going to read his post. I'm going to read it. This is the post from Eric Monte, the brother that we showed in the beginning who got robbed by Norman Lear, the Amalekite. He said, let's be very clear. We don't approve of this cartoon and have nothing to do with it. This coon show is not our work. Please spread the word. Eric Monte will not be getting paid for this. Norman Lear is still stealing from him. How is nigga still stealing from you when he dead?
That's way.
Nothing you can do. If that ain't the devil, who is?
The devil.
Nigga go to his grave stealing from you.
Damn.
Call the shots. Hey, he was born to do this.
That's so Howard.
And died to do it,
and
too.
And died to do it.
Go ahead. Keep playing.
In a way that could mislead audiences that they were affiliated with the animated version. Carlina Evans, daughter of co-creator Mike Evans, has also spoken out about the matter, as she would reveal in a recent interview, expressing that it was expected for the animated series to have gone through the proper protocol because Eric Monte and Mike Evans own the intellectual property of the show, while Sony only owns the show.
All righty. So now give me the next thing. So they do not approve of the new show and it was stolen once again without their consent. So they're like, man, we ain't got a damn thing to do with this.
Hell no.
Now we showed it in the beginning, but it been a little minute. All right. But this somebody they gonna give their remarks. And this is the, you could say, general consensus of most of our people and how they reacting to it. All right, play that.
Burn this.
I'm sorry?
This must never be seen by anyone.
Oh boy, here we go again. Netflix has done it again, y'all. Today we'll be talking about the reboot of Good Times. The dad's name is Reggie. The mom's name is Beverly. They have a son named Junior. They have a daughter named Gray. And she's supposed to be like the knockoff Huey Freeman. And then they got a drug dealer baby named Dalvin. You know, on Family Guy back in the day, Stewie was a gay, like, sophisticated type dude based on Rex Harrison. That's his name. Pretty sophisticated dude. But you know who Dalvin is based off of? Cisco. It's a sad thing to see when we're all, you know, reduced to caricatures, man. Seth MacFarlane is a piece of shit. Steph Curry, you a piece of shit.
Light skin.
Renata Shepherd, you a piece of shit. I feel like everybody involved with this show, you know, was definitely here for a check. This is probably the most disgusting, fucked up shit, like, that I've ever seen Netflix do, that I've seen on TV. And Norman Lear is responsible for this. That's the dude who created Good Times in the first place, you know? And I feel like we're really being spit in the face with this garbage. Spit in the face. They're spitting in our faces with this garbage, y'all. And I won't be supporting it. I won't be supporting it at all. I will be doing a review of the first episode.
Give me 2 Timothy 3, verse 13. So Norman Lear created in the first place, and it was wicked in the first place, to where the actors and the writers couldn't stand it. People lost their job over it, so on and so forth. And, you know, over time, black people look back at it thinking it was something good. Just to, you know, examine it and be like, hold on, this wasn't right to begin with.
Hold up.
The same evil man that made it 50 years ago when he revived it before he left the earth, he exponentially increased the wickedness within.
The book of 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 13.
Come on.
But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived.
So the Bible said that it's only going to get worse. This is a prime example. The man made it. It was a damn disaster in the beginning. And now, 50 years later, it's 50 times worse. Lord, have mercy. All right? Now, go to the next clip.
God, I'm going to hold you accountable for this.
Go to the TikTok. So this brother, this one of the woke brothers, but he gonna break it down. He gonna get into it.
This is the Netflix reboot of the show Good Times. I think we need to boycott this one. My name is Brother Legend, and I'm here to raise your consciousness. This show is already problematic for so many reasons. I'm just gonna give you three and keep it pushing. The first one is, how you gonna have a show talking about black people and the black struggle and black families, and it's produced by two members of the Cauliflower Coalition? I've never seen Steph Curry's name in the credits before, but I feel like he's just there as a token. But this is something Seth MacFarlane is known to do. For those of you that don't know, Seth MacFarlane is the creator of Family Guy and The Cleveland Show. You can't find me one show about a white family with all black producers. But somehow, this guy has gotten away with four seasons of making fun of black stereotypes and black trauma. Not to mention, this is the voice actor of the father in the show, which is literally blackface.
Damn!
Aside from the stereotypes of obesity. Whoa. And
it might have went over their head. The butter might have slipped. Slipped over the biscuit.
Slow it down.
So, in a generational evil, right, of racism, has been a thing called blackface.
Right.
Where a white person will, you know, paint their face black and parade themselves as black for entertainment. They literally been doing that on the Cleveland Show its entire existence.
Right.
The main character, the voice behind the black main character, has been a white man the whole entire time.
Wow.
Oh my God.
Black father.
Oh my God.
White man this whole time.
Ain't no way, boy.
Wow.
And this is the man that's creating this new Good Times.
Crazy.
Think God is not going to hold you guilty for
that's
that?
That's got to be racist. And people just think they the best people ever.
You're racist.
That's right.
Man, they like, these are
best. We going to prove it. All right, but play on.
With all black producers. But somehow, this guy has gotten away with four seasons of making fun of black stereotypes and black trauma. Not to mention, this is the voice actor of the father in the show, which is literally blackface. Aside from the stereotypes of obesity and promiscuous curvy women, the second reason it's problematic is because in the Good Times reboot, Seth MacFarlane once again adultifies a young black boy. The adultification of young black boys is the reason why they get longer sentences and more incarcerated.
Damn.
It's the reason they have a harder time in school and are more likely to be disciplined. But to Seth MacFarlane, this is funny somehow, because in Good Times, he's decided to include a drug-dealing baby in the show. And I can go into this a lot further, but I'm going to keep it pushing, like I said. The
pause
last reason this-
pause it. Pause. That's some heavy stuff. That's some heavy stuff right there. The white, listen, the vices, give me that in Isaiah 32.
Here we go.
About the device of the child. You know what I'm talking about? You don't know what I'm talking about. Isaiah 32 in verse 7. Yep.
The book of Isaiah chapter 32 and verse 7.
So this is talking about liberals, right? And this is how you get TV shows like Family Guy, The Cleveland Show, and all of that. That's how you get these weird productions of white people producing black shows. This is what this is in the scriptures. Read that.
The instruments also of the churl are evil.
The churl is the liberal. When you read verse 5 and 6, it's the vile person and it's the liberal, right? Who we call liberal, they make it seem like that's a good thing. That's the Democrats, you know, et cetera.
Cap.
But the Bible calls them vile, meaning nasty, filthy, disgusting, and the churl. Look up churl real quick. C-H-U-R-L.
We going to keep teaching. That's it.
All right. The Bible calls the white man the churl. Put that on the screen.
Churl. Right.
An impolite and mean-spirited person.
Give me the archaic. This the Bible definition right here.
A person of low birth.
A what?
A person of low birth.
A person of low birth. What the Bible calls in Daniel chapter 4, the basest men. You understand? They are the basest men in the damn earth, the damn bumpkins. All right?
Peasant.
So, yes, a peasant. So, read it again in verse 7.
The instruments also of the churl.
So, how do this damn peasant, how do these people of low birth remain above God's people? They have instruments. They have strategies. They have tools. And they are what?
The instruments also of the churl are evil.
They are evil. The main thing being evil communications. You understand? And they will use a black face or a black voice to push that evil white peasant low birth agenda. You understand? Their instruments are evil. Hollywood is one of the main ones. Read.
He devised wicked devices to destroy the poor.
To do what?
To destroy the poor.
Who is the poor? According to the book of Isaiah, same book. It's the children of Israel. Wow. Isaiah 14:32. They instruments, their liberal instruments are used to destroy the Israelites. Go ahead.
With lying words.
With lie. Tell lie vision. That ain't how we live. How can white people with no black experience make a show to portray black experience?
Come on, it's lies.
Right. But it's to program you to think that that's what it is.
You don't find that suspicious?
Come on.
Even when the needy speaketh right.
Right. Now, you had something?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Can I get a first address? Chapter 5, verse 72. Hey, because think about this. Hey, Cap, like when we leave, when you, okay, you travel out of the country, right? One of the things that was stated was black people imagery. Over there, we go to Uganda, it's okay, no guns, no this, no that. It's just little theft crimes and, you know, you got the adultery, fornication, stuff like that. But no major crime like it is over here in America. Why is that they think that we, though it is the worst place you can be, why do they think that? Because it's pushed all around the globe, the media. Read this.
First Ezra chapter 5 and verse 72.
Come on.
But the heathen of the land, lying heavy upon the inhabitants of Judea.
This is what they doing because every time you turn on television, they're telling their lies. It's lying heavy upon us.
Right.
We are the inhabitants in this land. Come on.
And holding them straight, hinder their building.
This is what they're trying to do because this just came out or is supposed to premiere, what, April the 12th? They're trying to hinder the growth. The mission at hand is to raise the 12 tribes of Israel out of the decayed state they are in. This is our whole mission. So what they're doing is pushing out things. Read on.
And by their secret plots.
By their secret plots, when they in their own little chambers in their rooms, that when they sleep, when they think and they activate these things, come on.
And popular persuasion.
This is what they doing. They pushing it across the airways to popular persuasion. Say, no, a nigga is no good. This is how the mama should look. She used to say, hey, Jesus is white. Son, shut up with the black image. You can have him for 1 week and you're done.
What?
Now, okay, the little kid that was once in a good time trying to be educated, young boy that was outspoken about his people. Now he's a freaking drug dealer in a cartoon. Who watched cartoons today? Little kids. Popular persuasion, pushing it around to stop the growth of a nation. This is what we see today. Finish it out.
And popular persuasions and commotions. They hinder the finishing of the building all the time that King Cyrus lived.
That's what I want. Hey, so this is what they're trying to do is hinder the building at hand. But they can't stop it. They can't stop because we're bringing out the truth. Right. All praises.
I will embarrass you.
Trying to buy time, bro. Right. Trying to buy time. Like the Judah 5. You know what I'm saying? When, you know, they trying to prolong the time. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Can we pull that real quick? Judah 5 and 20. Because we pull the scripture all the time.
Right.
But it's deeper than what, you know, phase level. I mean, you really got to understand the scripture that this is really what the white man do.
Watch the white man.
The book of Judah chapter 5, verse 20. Now, therefore, my lord and governor, if there be any error in this people, and they sin against their God.
And they what?
And they sin against their God.
That's their whole objective, to keep our people in sin. And they're going to find ways to do it. They're going to be crafty with it. Read.
Let us consider that this shall be their ruin. And let us go up, and we shall overcome them.
Read.
But if there be no iniquity in their nation, let my Lord now pass by, lest their Lord defend them.
Lest what?
Lest their Lord defend them. And that God be for them, and we become a reproach before all the world.
Hey, the heathen, they understood that way back in the Bible times, thousands of years ago, bro. You see what I'm saying? And they doing the same thing now. They know if they keep our people in sin, they know that their kingdom is going to steadily be prolonged.
To this day!
All right, come on. Go back. I know we ain't finished it, right? Yep. Press play.
Problematic is because it's literally the reason John Amos, the dad from the original Good Times, left the show. After three long seasons, John Amos left the show because he didn't like the direction of the character JJ. You know, the one whose catchphrase was dynamite. He felt the show was focusing too much on JJ's comedic antics at the expense of other important serious storylines. Additionally, Amos had concerns about the lack of diversity in the writing team and how the scripts portrayed African-American characters. He believed that the white writers' perceptions of black family and black fatherhood did not align with his own experiences, and basically, it wasn't reflective of reality. And so here we are once again with a Good Times reboot with characters that aren't reflective of black reality, written by and executive produced by non-black people. If you want part two, I can get into it. Let me know. One love.
All righty. So put the Edomite on the screen. When he made the first point, this is the creator of the show. It's taking the reins of Norman Lear, Seth MacFarlane.
The white man.
The same guy who did Family Guy in the Cleveland show. All right. Now give me the clip of Family Guy. Just some moments. Hopefully this don't get a strike. But, you know, just some of the stuff that he has a history of putting in his content. All right, play that.
That truck's coming up on us awful fast.
Holy crap! Do you see what I see?
I'm afraid I do.
We're being chased by ghosts!
Oh, come on, it's not that bad. Your life could be worse. You could be a blah.
Go ahead.
A blanket.
I'm just a stupid old blanket.
Damn.
What a lousy life this is.
All right, you saved it.
I had our wedding.
Oh, you look beautiful. And he's a handsome fella, ain't he?
Well, I am ready for my evening.
Oh, my God, Peter. What the hell?
Peter, what are you doing?
Oh, surely, Jerome, you don't want to stay in the same house as a ghost who carries a torch around. Ooh, fire ghost. Ooh, you scared yet? Didn't know this place was haunted, did you?
Okay, nobody move!
Oh, my God, those guys in first class have guns!
Cleveland, just be happy with what you have. Don't envy people.
Died not 30 minutes ago in the carriage on the way here.
Well, we all know how this goes. I'm doing it!
Hey, Lois, I'd like you to meet our new friend.
Jerome?
Loose Lois.
You guys know each other?
Know each other? Peter, Jerome is an old boyfriend of mine.
What?
Oh, sorry, I was out of it. Wait, are we being robbed?
My ass.
Man, this trip is dangerous. Couldn't we have just taken a bus?
No, it's a black guy.
Ooh, a message from Joe.
Hey, Cleveland, I just wanted to give you a heads up that Peter has a whip because, well, you know,
Given your racial heritage, it seems like something you might want to keep an eye out for.
Grape soda, Graham.
I know this is very risky, but the upside is so good, I'm taking it.
Lois, to show I'm in touch with what it's like to be African-American, I am going to go to the middle of the town square, get naked, and paint myself brown.
No, no, that's offensive. You can't pretend to be black. That's a stupid idea.
What?
It's a stupid idea! You're a stupid man! A stupid, stupid man!
Ow! You're hurting me! Stop it! Stop it, Lois!
No! I'm so sick of your crap! Why do you always do these stupid things? And why do you always announce them to me before you do them? Are you trying to get a rise out of me?
9/11 changed everything, Brian. 9/11 changed everything.
Now get Psalms 44, verse 13.
You can't make this
stuff
up.
So that's the creator of the new rejuvenated version of Good Times.
Oh!
The man who made all that shit.
Come on, man.
You can't make this up. Play that, read that, I mean.
The book of Psalms, chapter 44 and verse 14.
Bring
it out. Verse 13.
Come on.
Thou makest us a reproach to our neighbors.
The word reproach means a term of disrespect, something derogatory. God has made us reproach to our neighbors, to our enemies. Go ahead.
A scorn and a derision to them that are round about us.
We are a scorn and a derision, right? Meaning they don't care about us. They don't want us around them. They can't stand us. They hate our guts. And they talk about us in our face in a slick way and behind our back to the utmost. You understand? Because we broke God's commandments. Go ahead.
Thou makest us a byword among the heathen.
Uh-huh.
A shaking of the head among the people.
A shaking of the head among the people. That's how we're portrayed by television.
My confusion is continually before me.
Uh-huh.
And the shame of my face hath covered me.
Why?
For the voice of him that reproacheth.
For the voice of him that reproacheth us, like Seth MacFarlane. Go ahead.
And blaspheme.
And blasphemeth. Right? How do they blaspheme? What's the main way they blaspheme? They call the so-called white men the Jews, and they say that Jesus is a white man.
Come on now, dog.
By reason of the enemy and avenger.
Right, right. Reason of the enemy and avenger. So from there, give me the next clip. So I told y'all we was going to get to this point. This is the attitude of the black people that's acting or, you know, doing the voice roles, right? Now, remember, we showed y'all what happened to the actors that took a stand aforetime in the old Good Times. What happened to them? They got cut off. And what is their breed? Their breed's niggas that either comply or go bye-bye. You understand? And we have been conditioned. Listen, we about this chick to hell with all that other stuff, right? And we will sell our soul. Like the scriptures say, you'll set your soul for sale. So this just going to show you the mindset that's so contrary to that of, what's the brother name, Amos? James Amos, right. This show you the new black man on Good Times. All right, play that. Come on.
Obviously, there are some people, and I don't even know if people, from what I've seen, and I don't know what you're getting, they're not necessarily criticizing the cast. It seems like they're more so criticizing
the brand,
the show, yeah, the show and like things like that. So what's been your reaction to the criticism when people talk about like, oh, you know, seeing Good Times in this light, in this animated series? It's, of course, people are talking about like it being for kids. Like, I can't sit down and watch it with my kids, you know, seeing babies with guns and like all these different type of things. And I think that's your character. So What's your reaction to the criticism?
Oh, man. Wow. Good Time streaming April 12th on Netflix. Check out Good Time streaming April 12th on Netflix.
What?
Oh, my feeling is this. You know, I got a whole lot of feelings. You know, I'm a parent. I have 5 children that I'm very active and involved in all their lives, and I love them to death. And you know, to point on what you said about it's not for children, it's not for children. It's not for children. I am a parent, and this is a whole nother conversation, but the internet and social media is a Pandora's box that you have to control as a parent because it's not my job to raise your kids. You have to filter what comes into your home. Now, you as a parent have to be the one with the gift of discernment to understand.
Did y'all see the hypocrisy? Now, his first response was, is streaming. He shouted out the good time stream on da-da-da-da-da. Yeah. So you promote that it's going to show, and then you turn around and say, well, if you got a problem, then don't play it in your house, right?
Right.
Looking at it.
So, wait a minute.
You want the streams because that's what pay you. You don't give a damn about what them kids watching or what they not watching. You understand?
Now,
you just got to say that to sound like you not the evil damn black sellout that you
dummy,
is.
Right.
What the hell is this? Keep playing. Come on.
With the gift of discernment to understand reality and satire.
Hey, Pop, give me, hold on real quick. Give me Psalms 141 and verse 4. So this should be the mindset. This is why James Amos got fired. This is why certain people are not okay when a white man tries to portray poor representation of our people. You understand? This is the mindset that the black man needs in 2024. Read that.
The book of Psalms, chapter 141, verse 4.
Come on.
Incline not my heart to any evil thing, to practice wicked works with men that work iniquity.
So we got to pray for that thing. Lord, do not incline my heart to practice wicked works with them that work iniquity.
Right.
Don't put a price on my mind to compromise my integrity to sit up there and push evil on my people.
Don't
you understand? Don't cause my heart to go that way. Read.
And let me not eat of that dainty.
Ah, that's what it is. That's how they gonna lure you in. Mm-hmm. That's how they gonna get you to not give a damn. It's the dainties. It's the money. It's the fame. The recognition. You understand? Then you will compromise. Then you will sit up there and practice wicked works with them that work iniquity and be defiled with them in their sins. Right. And partake in the destruction of your people by way of evil communication. That would not be possible without your black voice.
Hell no.
So go back.
Because it's not my job to raise your kids. You have to filter what comes into your home. Now, you as a parent have to be the one with the gift of discernment to understand reality and satire. That's it.
Yeah.
Some things are satirical. I'm sorry if it might hurt your feelings, but it's satire.
Yeah, when I saw the criticism, and like I said, we talked about it on the show.
Hey, give me that in Proverbs 26. Proverbs 26, verse 19. It's satire. It's just comedy. It's just games. It's just a joke.
Cap. You think.
So remember what we read. The white man, the thought of every one of them is deep.
Right.
We see the Section 8 and all of that, that pandemic started during that era.
The devil.
That show literally prepared. It played as an engine behind that agenda of Section 8 Project Living and the black woman pushing a black man out of the household.
Yeah. Oh my God!
You understand? But it's just satire. Nah, the white man know it ain't no damn satire.
Hell no!
What is this? Yo, read what you got.
Proverbs chapter 26 and verse 19.
Come on.
So is the man that deceiveth his neighbor and saith, am not I in sport?
God don't like a nigga like that. You understand? You're partaking some BS, and then once you get confronted about it, you get put on the spot. I'm just playing. I'm just a comedian, bro. Yeah. Why so serious?
Okay.
You understand?
Playing away.
Read on.
Where no wood is, there the fire.
That's all I want. All right, go back to the video. Go back.
Yeah, when I saw the criticism, and like I said, we talked about it on the show. My thing was when we heard from Eric Monty's family, like not agreeing with it. The only thing I thought was like I would have loved for them to, you know, be on the back end. But again, I would too. Yeah, I wouldn't. Nothing to do with the cast. But that was my main thing. Was like I wish they could have been a part of it on the back.
No, and you know one thing for sure. You know, you stressed that that's not part of the cast. No, I never take it at that. I never take it as that, because I never take it personally, because if it wasn't me, they'd be saying the same thing.
Right.
If it wasn't whoever, if it wasn't the people involved, it was a whole new cast of characters, they still had the same thing to say about it. So that's neither here nor there. Don't knock it till you try. Watch it. Check it out, man.
Hold on. Notice how he did not address how the original, the brain behind the original idea of Good Times, the families disagree with it. He did not acknowledge that.
Right.
He did not speak on that. He man, the cast. I don't worry about what they say about the cast, but look, it's stream on this day. Make sure you check it out.
You don't find that.
You understand? He know he can't speak against the evil that was done by them not consulting with the people that came up with that own the intellectual property of the show.
Right.
You understand? He couldn't address that evil that was done. This nigga is, he cast his damn bowels away.
Sell out.
I will embarrass
you. Listen, it's something about coons that get me to the point to where I'm almost at the spirit. like it be the good anger, like to fire it up, and you know I gotta stay in the scriptures with it.
Some Peter on there.
But hey, in Africa, when we was in Africa, did nothing get me more fired, cause I'm like, damn, you in Africa. Everybody you see is black. And you got a problem with God being black?
Man.
You damn grown. That got me so fired up in Africa, bro. I was finna snatch some damn Ugandans up, bro. I'm telling you. Listen, I almost took look. What that little nickname was? The little short one. It's on the last day. I almost lifted him up by the damn collar. Because he was like, you know how Christians try to do. You know how Christians try to do. Because we got on the sign the image of the beast, Revelation 13 and 15.
Right.
So when you was teaching, he want to get up. I studied verse 1. Studied verse 1. All of that, right? So I'm like, hold on. Nigga, I studied verse 1. Let's go. Let's do it. I will break down Revelation 13, 1 through 15 with you right now. I get to breaking it down. You understand? This nigga gonna turn it back.
Not listening.
I'm like, bro, I did what you wanted me to do and you not listening. You damn. Throw the goon away. Throw the goon away.
It started to make more and more
nothing
sense.
Nothing worse than an African coon, bro. I'm telling you.
That's why Christ flipped tables, man.
Listen, in America, we use it's like, all right, nigga. You understand? But an African coon is crazy.
The
African
worst.
Coon is wild.
Bro, it's some African coons, bro. Them brothers.
We ran into a couple of them, man. Comes on steroids.
For real.
Get out. The New Testament songs, brother.
Right. Yes, definitely. Bruh. Because, you know, I'm lame. You know, I'd be chilling. You wouldn't even think that I. But in that coon spirit.
Get out.
I'll pray to the Most High. Bro, you finish that clip, man. Finish that clip. Come on.
If it wasn't the people involved, it was a whole new cast of characters. They still had the same thing to say about it. So that's neither here nor there. Don't knock it till you try. Watch it. Check it out, man. It's satire. It's, you know. No, it's not the original Good Times. It's like you not your grandparents.
Wow.
Simple. It's a different time, different climate. You not your grandparents. You know, your grandmother was a strong, virtuous woman. Now look at you. You was a floozy at the hookah bar.
Mm.
Your grandfather used to have a cold 2-3 jobs. Now look at you. You still selling nickels and breeding pit bulls. Shut up.
This nigga trying to deflect.
Hey, so Slick, let me ask you, do you understand?
That's it, y'all. That's the timestamp, brothers. Pay attention. All right? But give me Ecclesiastes real quick. Ecclesiastes chapter 1.
You can't make this stuff up.
Different times. Ecclesiastes 1 verse 9. The
book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 1 and verse 9.
Just like you, not your grandparents. Read that.
The thing that hath been, it is that which shall be. Mm-hmm. And that which is done is that which shall be done. And there is no new thing under the sun.
Right. So, no, we are our grandparents. It's the same damn thing going on back then. The difference is you don't got the balls that John Amos had to sit up there and, you know what I'm saying, contest against the evil that they have you practicing, that using you as an instrument, as the instrument of the churl.
Get some balls, brother!
They got the clip.
Is this a clip of, okay. What y'all got?
I will break down Revelation 13.
Stop cheating. Give it to nobody.
The book of Revelation, chapter 13, verse 1.
Hey.
And I stood upon the sand of the sea. And saw a beast. And saw a beast rise out of the sea.
The beast rising up out of the sea is the white man.
Yes,
come on. Hey, I
won't
break down
right. That's what I'm saying. See, I be on the edge of the spirit. I'm still in it.
Back up.
I'm still in it. Right. Well, they give me the edge.
That's right.
Can't show everything, y'all.
We gonna keep teaching. That's it.
Lord have mercy. Yeah, what is it? Isaiah 5:20.
I will embarrass you.
Isaiah 5:20.
The book of Isaiah 5:20.
Come on.
Woe unto them that call evil good.
That do what?
That call evil good.
At the end of the day, bro, you got to call a spade a spade. If it ain't right, it ain't right. It's satire. And check it out. No. God said, woe unto them that call evil good. God is going to hold you accountable for being partaking and pushing poison on your people.
And God is not what it is. Guilty for that.
Woe to them that call evil good. Come on.
And good evil.
Read.
That put darkness for light and light for darkness.
That put darkness for light and light for darkness. So if there's you trying to justify these evil deeds, this evil propaganda against our people, God said, warn to you. Meaning what?
You're going to die! Yeah. You're going to die!
Yeah. All right? I'll praise the Most High. All right. So I'll praise the Most High. That's what I got on the topic, y'all, as far as, you know, tell our vision, good times then and now. All right? I guess we can spend a little time if y'all got anything. What's up, Osiris?
Just 1 Corinthians 15.
Bring it up.
Let's bring this out. We got to, y'all, because at the end of the day, he can say all that BS he just said, but we know kids going to scroll across it and watch it. It's on Netflix, one of the number one streaming platforms for watching videos, movie, whatever.
Damn.
And we people turn it on and watch it. You going to censor millions of people, billions of people across the globe? Come on. And remember, this is the same dude probably think he a Christian. I love God. I love Jesus. Yeah, sure. Read that.
So, because he got a role on a channel called where he plays what? Black Jesus?
Black Jesus.
He plays Black Jesus, him, on another show.
This man is a straight hypocrite, man.
Rolled the blunts up and everything.
Damn.
He's a mocker.
He's a mocker. Yeah, hypocrite. That, right.
Damn.
The book of 1 Corinthians 15:33.
No.
Be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt good manners.
At the end of the day, this is what evil communication does. It corrupts good manners. From an innocent child that don't know big booty women with breasts, they don't understand all that. They're not privy to that.
Yeah,
but because the communication across the globe, the evil communication, people flock into that. Our kids learn these ways and they get corrupted. Right? The teachers for they once knew when they're growing up in the school. Hey, stay away from girls. Remember when you used to grow up, cooties was a thing, right? You kiss a girl, it's cooties. Now they put it on TV. It's the right thing to do. If you ain't had a kiss yet, what's wrong with you? You weird. That's the evil communication today. And the Bible says, read it again.
Be not deceived.
Uh-huh.
Evil communications corrupt good manners.
This is for all the adults, the ones that have children out there. Listen. Don't be deceived. Evil communication corrupt good manners.
Flawless victory.
King Simple, I mean King Super, he said he definitely at novice level, he malfunctioned swiftly. I guess Phineas and Mattathias was at novice level too.
Right.
When they saw the nigga Conan and went and slayed him in the tent, and Mattathias killed the nigga on the altar.
Right.
They couldn't stand the damn coon.
Right.
It made their blood, bro. It said they was inflamed with zeal. I guess they was at novice level too.
Nehemiah was.
All right, King Simple. All right. Whatever. All right, so DD.
His name King Simple?
All right, so DD, it says, Shalom, Cap. This may be a little bit off topic, but I was wondering, how much leisure time do you suggest giving to the Most High in order to be properly fed and to become rooted and to quench all distractions? Get Sirach chapter 43 and verse 30. Go to scripture. All right, all your leisure time. I mean, when you think about it, well, just read that. Let's see.
The book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 43, verse 30.
Come on.
When ye glorify the Lord,
uh-huh,
exalt him as much as ye can.
Do what?
Exalt him as much as ye can.
That's the answer right there. Exalt him as much as you can. Go ahead.
For even yet will he far exceed.
Uh-huh.
And when ye exalt him, put forth all your strength.
Read.
And be not weary. For ye can never go far enough. You
can never go far enough. Get Sirach 38:24. And the Lord rewards you. Once you give him, once you devote your leisure time to you, he recompenses that with the reward of wisdom. Understand? Read that real quick.
Ecclesiasticus chapter 38, verse 24.
Come on.
The wisdom of a learned man cometh by opportunity of leisure.
So you want to get wiser, which causes you to draw nigh unto the Lord. Wisdom is your connection with the Most High God. You understand? If you want to establish that connection and make it stronger, that comes by opportunity of leisure. So give it all. You understand?
Right.
Go ahead.
And he that hath little business shall become wise.
Right, so the less distractions you have, the more wiser you can become, and it's true. The more time you can study, travel, get around leadership, watch classes, be exercised in the laws of God. All right? For real. I know it be sounding far-fetched to some people, but, you know, that's how we supposed to live. This is our life. Our life is here with Christ in God.
That's right!
All right, y'all, that's it. He said, got him. King Simple did that. Did what?
What?
Okay,
this dude don't got nothing better to do. What you doing?
Got a Christian cross right there.
They been trolling the whole thing.
Okay, I'm still looking at the phone they got on the screen.
All
right. Esau put them shows up to show their children how stupid we can be. Facts. Making mockery. That's what they do. That's what they do. Alright. Let me see. You go there. Yo, pressure make a wise man mad. Exactly. Awesome breakdown. I'll pray to the Most High. Friday night. Fire up. Thank you. All praise to the Most High, Khalil.
Hey,
I'll
can
pray.
I get a scripture?
Go ahead. Damn, who
there
is that?
Go.
Hey,
there
who
go.
Woke up Frankenstein?
Brother been sleep.
The hell is this?
Let me get a Nehemiah 9:36-37.
Yeah.
The book of Nehemiah.
Crazy.
Chapter 9 and verse 36. Behold, we are servants this day. And for the land that thou gavest unto our fathers to eat the fruit thereof, so, and the good thereof.
So the so-called black man, Hispanic man, we servants in the enemy's land right now. We don't.
Behold, we are servants in it. And it yielded much increase unto the kings whom thou hast set over us because of our sins.
So these TV shows, we make them money for our sins.
Right.
Also, they have dominion over our bodies.
They have what?
They have dominion over our bodies.
So they got dominion over our bodies. They can take us out anytime they want to. They can give us vaccine shots, you know, the entertainers, the basketball players, we don't.
And over our cattle at their pleasure.
At their pleasure. So, hey, we got to stop sinning.
That's right.
Someone said, if thou responded to my other comments, respond to scripture. What scripture you put? What scripture he gave?
He didn't put no scriptures.
King Simple, the hell is
what? This? Go to bed.
Go to sleep, Hope. If you're tired, be quiet and go to sleep, Hope.
Damn. All
right. So Didi said, I have another question. I don't know if it might be a little too deep, but can we ask Christ to pray for us?
Hey.
Lord have mercy.
Freedom.
Get to Romans 8. The Spirit make intercession. He do that anyway. All
right. That's right.
Romans 8, 26.
The book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 26.
Come on.
Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities.
Uh-huh.
For we know it not what we should pray for as we ought.
Come on.
But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered.
That's a cold priest.
There you go. Read.
And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit.
That is talking about Christ. Read.
Because he maketh intercession for the saints.
He does what?
Maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God.
So all praise to the Most High. Didi, it's already done. And it's already done. Looking at it. Glory to God.
We're going to keep teaching. That's it.
All right. In the kingdom, we're gonna have a TV show called Great Time. Hey, for real, we gonna write the script for some damn white shows.
Right.
Real. The scriptures say the curse gonna get that in Deuteronomy 30.
Yes, sir.
Today gonna become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword. You understand? Yep. To however that thing come to pass, it's gonna come to pass. Deuteronomy 30:7. This one is one of my favorite scriptures.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 30 and verse 7.
Come on.
And the Lord thy God will put all these curses upon thine enemies.
All these curses. So they gonna become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations where we sell that. Yeah, what it is. And I ain't mad at it. Right. Yeah.
It's a cold precept. All
right. Sheesh. So not one scripture pops up. Why he sticking his tongue out? What's wrong with King Self?
Come on now, dog.
Out of my
no, Diddy, bro.
He probably think Jesus like, white.
Him and Tyrone McNeese, they take turns. I think Tyrone the clone went to sleep, though.
It's
hey, 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 hey,
all right, so Diddy said, is there an example in the scriptures of anyone overcoming slothfulness? That's a good question right there. Is it an example of anyone overcoming slothfulness? Haggai chapter 1. Yes, sir. Let's read that. Haggai 1, start at verse 1.
The book of Haggai, chapter 1, verse 1.
Come on.
In the second year of Darius the king, in the sixth month, in the first day of the month, came the word of the Lord by Haggai the prophet unto Zerubbabel. Unto Zerubbabel.
Zerubbabel, read.
The son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah.
So he was the governor of Judah. This is the time that we was able to go back to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple. The Persians gave us leave to do so. And Zerubbabel was set up as the governor. Go ahead.
And to Joshua, the son of Josedech, the high priest, saying, thus speaketh the Lord of hosts, saying, this people say, The time has not come. The time that the Lord's house should be built.
So they got slothful. They got relaxed. They said it ain't time for the Lord's house to be built. So it was being prolonged. They was procrastinating. Go ahead.
Then came the word of the Lord by Haggai the prophet, saying, is it time for you, O ye, to dwell in your sealed houses, and this house lie waste?
So that's what they was doing. They was chilling in the crib while the house of God was still not rebuilt as yet. So the Lord sent Haggai to address their slothfulness. Jump down to verse 14.
Verse 14.
Come on.
And the Lord stirred up the spirit of Zerubbabel, the son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, and the spirit of Joshua, the son of Josedech, the high priest, and the spirit of all the remnants of the people.
So the Lord used Haggai with his words, with his rebuke, to stir them up, to stir up their spirit. Go ahead.
And they came and did work in the house.
What?
And they came and did work in the house of the Lord of hosts, their God.
So they went from being slothful in the house, chilling while the Lord's house laid waste, to going and doing the work. They overcame the spirit of slothfulness by hearkening to the words of the prophet. All right, so there you go. That's an example. What? It says, what kind of sex can we have with our wife and what we shouldn't? Get Colossians 3. Colossians 3 and 5. Scriptures say, Hebrews 13 and 4, the bed is undefiled. Right? Meaning, you can do it with your wife how you want to do it. Except, because remember what it say in 1 Corinthians 6, abusers of themselves with mankind. What is that talking about? What is the abuse of yourself? It's when you allow a rod to enter your exit only hole as a man. So if you put a strap on your wife and she abuse you, you understand you are still using mankind as a woman, you understand, to abuse you.
Message.
That ain't right. So
hell no.
We'll read that real quick.
The book of Colossians, chapter 3 and verse 5.
Come on.
Mortify therefore your members.
You got to mortify your members, man. Read.
Which are upon the earth.
Read.
Fornication. Uncleanness. Inordinate affection.
Inordinate affection. You crave an affection, the same affection that a sodomite has, but you're trying to fulfill it using your wife.
Come on now, dog.
You can't do that. All right?
Just this ain't right.
Keep it man and woman. You understand? As long as you operating in the realm of man and woman with no extra device to pervert that interaction, you good. The bed under foul. All right, it is what it is.
That's right.
Did I miss something? All right, it say, can you explain a proper process to godly sorrow once you've been removed from the body for sin? I find it hard to do due to the pride that I deal with trying to break the habit. Well, that's the first step right there. The pride. You got to humble yourself. Get that in Sirach chapter 7. Sirach chapter 7 and verse 17. So the fact that you removed from the body, that means you've been delivered unto Satan. You understand? So you, it's either you bounce back from that or you, hell, you the hell bound. You understand? So if it's pride that's the problem or the root of the problem, that's where you got to start. Read that.
The book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 7 and verse 17.
Come on.
Humble thy soul greatly.
Do what?
Humble thy soul greatly.
God says, humble your soul greatly. Come on.
For the vengeance of the ungodly is fire and worms.
Meaning if you remain in your pride and you fail to humble yourself, that's what is on reserve for you. You understand? Hellfire and worms. Meaning you will burn forever. So you must humble yourself. That's number one. I guess Psalms 32 and 5. Psalms 32, verse 5.
The book of Psalms, chapter 32, verse 5. Uh-huh. I acknowledged my sin unto thee, and mine iniquity have I not hid.
Uh-huh.
I said, I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord.
Come on.
And thou forgavest the iniquity of my sin.
Read.
Selah.
Read.
For this shall everyone that is godly pray unto thee in a time.
Read that part again.
For this shall everyone that is godly pray unto thee in a time when thou mayest be found.
But in verse 5, it say iniquity and sin. But in verse 6, this is what everyone that is godly shall pray. Remember, the scriptures say a just man falleth 7 times. Just because you got put out because of sin does not mean that you can't recover yourself and be righteous.
That's right.
The fact that the spirit ain't left you and you still tuning in to Friday Night Raw, that's a sign the Lord's still trying to deal with you. Right? But you have to acknowledge that iniquity, acknowledge that sin. You understand that God, well, I didn't feel in the sin before. I done been put out before. You understand? It is what it is. But you got to acknowledge to the Most High where you put your pride to the side and address that evil, that sin that's within you. A lot of times we get rebuked, we get corrected, we get judged, and we get to thinking about the person that passed it. Well, how he going to throw me out when I know he ain't perfect and I know he it ain't about him. It ain't about the person that the Lord used to judge you. The Lord is the judge. The Lord was with them in the judgment. Read that in Deuteronomy 1. Deuteronomy chapter 1, I believe it's verse 17.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 17. He shall not respect persons in judgment.
Uh-huh.
But ye shall hear the small as well as the great. Ye shall not be afraid of the face of man, for the judgment is God's.
There you go. That's what I wanted. The judgment is God's. So God decided to put you out. That's the judgment that he saw meet for you. And he said in their affliction, they'll seek me early. The Lord putting you in that position because that's the position you need to be in to seek him as you should.
I am here to
restore your spirit to get right with the Lord. So put your pride to the side, humble yourself, and converse with the Lord concerning your evil, your sin, what got you put out in the first place. All right? And then from there, you should have a point of contact. Somebody that even though you've been put out is somebody that's still in a body that you have been assigned to that you can still talk to and update and let them know your status and the things that you're going through. You have to reach out to them. You understand? You must reach out to them. And eventually, through you humbling yourself, you repenting, you getting your spirit right, forsaking your sin, and being in contact with that point of contact, then the Lord will put the spirit on them to bring you back. All right, that's how it go. It ain't calculus. It ain't rocket science. You know what I'm saying? That's how you recover yourself. All right. I'm finna answer like one or two more. I am not Deacon Ace.
Tiki, y'all scroll up a little bit?
For real, though.
It was Thursday, like Psalm 34:1. But yeah, what does it mean to?
Thanks, Cap. I got more. What does it mean to bless the Lord? Like Psalms 34, verse 1. To bless the Lord, get collage. Read that. What he quoted real quick. Psalms 34, verse 1.
The book of Psalms, chapter 34, verse 1.
Come on.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth.
Right. So that's a good precept right there. To bless him means to praise him or to thank him. Right? Like when somebody tell you something good or give you something and you be like, God bless you. Right? You're basically thanking someone or returning a favor. So get Psalms 116 real quick about render. I believe it's verse 12.
The book of Psalms, chapter 116 and verse 12.
Come on.
What shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits toward me?
Right. So that's how you bless the Lord with that thought process. How do I return a favor for what all the Lord has done unto me, all the benefits that he give me? What does he want from me? Right? He wants you to keep his commandments, obviously. Right? That's how you praise him. That's how you worship him. but also verbal thanksgiving. Get that in Colossians chapter 4. Colossians chapter 4, verse 6.
The book of Colossians?
No, Philippians 4, verse 6.
Yes, sir. The book of Philippians chapter 4 and verse 6.
Read.
Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving.
With what?
With thanksgiving.
So it ain't all about going to the Lord about asking him for forgiveness and requesting this and requesting that. Thank him for all everything else that he done already done and doing. And that you ain't seen him already do that he done did already. You understand?
Message.
That's how you bless the Lord. Read.
Let your requests be made known unto God.
All right. So. All right. One more. Oh, Cap, Ezekiel 4:13 going into modern Christianity with the defiled bread? Or am I going off? Yeah, you going off. All right, well, you going deep. I'm going to just say that. I don't know. Bishop might have a Job 11:6 breakdown for you, but I don't.
Damn.
I know what leadership breaking down is. The GMOs and et cetera. You understand that? What it is. That's how I understand it. I ain't going no deeper than that. All right. So this is the last question. What do you do when your teenage daughter don't want to follow the truth? That's a good. Y'all see how that work? See, I was going to go over some scriptures with that in the congregation tomorrow. Because we got somebody with a teenage daughter that don't want to follow the truth. It is what it is. In Matthew 10:34. Matthew chapter 10, verse 32. 34.
The book of Matthew, chapter 10 and verse 34.
Come on.
Think not that I am come to send peace on earth.
Read.
I came not to send peace, but a sword.
That's the grim reality of Christ. Christ came, is spiritual. We get so caught up in, oh, that's my family, that's my blood, blah, 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 blah. The Lord came to separate the children of light from the children of darkness. It could be your identical twin damn brother. But he could be a whole child of darkness and you the elect. You a child of light. You understand? Blood relation don't mean a damn thing in terms of who has God predestined.
Damn.
You understand? As his elect. It don't. And God, Christ, the purpose of him is to make that differentiation through the Spirit. Go ahead.
For I am come to set a man at variance against his father.
Watch this.
And the daughter against her mother.
No way.
And the daughter against her mother.
You see that? That's what Christ came to do.
Right.
Real plain.
It is what it is. That's a part of the plight. Read on. Watch this.
And the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law.
Come on.
And a man's foes shall be they of his own household.
Read.
He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me.
Come on.
And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me.
That's a trial. That's a trial right there. It's Sirach 16 verse 1. Hey. If you really believe in the Lord, okay. All right. I'm going to go and let the little wicked spirit manifest. Your daughter that you raised up, that you love so dearly, she's not going to repent for now.
Damn.
Let's see what you do. Read that.
The book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 16, verse 1.
Go ahead.
Desire not a multitude of unprofitable children.
You see what God said? Don't desire a multitude of unprofitable children. Read.
Neither delight in ungodly
sons. So if it's an ungodly son or a daughter, God said, don't delight in them. Read it. That's Bible. Come on.
Though they multiply, rejoice not in them.
Read.
Except the fear of the Lord be with them.
So unless the fear of the Lord with your daughter, hey, the Lord said, don't rejoice in them.
Damn. Damn
what it is. Was that it? All right, give me Matthew 19. I'm going to leave it off with this. A lot of us have been through that in this truth. You know what I'm saying? We had kids, spouses, you know, even brothers and sisters in this truth that was with you in the truth, you know, become casualties of spiritual war. All right? And you got to be willing to cut off their right hand and keep it pushing. So your whole body don't get tossed in the lake of fire with them.
Come on. The book of Matthew, chapter 19 and verse 29. And everyone that hath forsaken houses or brethren or sisters or father or mother or wife or children.
Or what?
Or children.
Or what?
Or children.
How would you have forsaken children? Children that chose the world. You understand? That chose not to follow you and stay in subjection to God's commandments. It happens. That's a part of the plight of believers of Christ. Read.
Or land, for my name's sake.
But watch this, though. Come on.
Shall receive an hundredfold.
You gonna do what?
Shall receive an hundredfold.
When you get the kingdom, the Lord gonna give you 100 righteous, modest, believing daughters that don't wanna go do with a rebellious teenage daughter. Man, you know, I was finna
utter a lot of things right then.
But I don't want to offend. You understand? But in the kingdom, the Lord will bless you with 100 daughters who are going to be righteous, pure, innocent. Come on.
And shall inherit everlasting life.
So you got 100 daughters in the kingdom with immortality. My wicked daughter, and I burn with her. You got to weigh it in a balance. What you want to do?
Right.
What you want to do?
Better take that good trade.
Man, for real, it is what it is.
That's right.
You know, it's easier said than done, per se. It ain't, that's a hard trial right there. Right. But if the Lord put that, he made that your trial, that means you could bear it. Because he's not going to put more on you than you could bear.
Message.
That's what the Bible say. All right? So be faithful. You never know. You know the parable about the prodigal son. She might have to go in that world and get dirty and deal with the piglets and shit for a while, and give away her the ride is living and all of that, and then come back. You know what I'm saying?
Damn,
that could happen too. You know, it is what it is. So hey, keep it pushing. Pray for her. But if she don't believe. Hey, you keep believing. You keep pushing. Desire not a multitude of unprofitable children.
That's right.
All praise to the Most High. Somebody said 100 daughters sound like hella responsibility. In the kingdom, the Lord's going to say to people, you're going to be ruled over 10 cities.
Come on now, dog.
You understand?
Come on, man.
I guess, I don't know, maybe you were Gentile just playing or something, playing around. The Lord gonna make us rulers over cities and nations and planets. And you tell me that. A hell of a responsibility, 100 daughters. That's
come on now, dog.
Isaiah 60 said they gonna be all right. We gonna be all righteous. What's gonna be hard about raising 100 righteous daughters? You crazy. Stop it.
They said they want the intro, the camp video intro. They've been
emailing
us.
All right, so all praise to the Most High. Make sure y'all go subscribe to IUIC Arkansas right now. And hit that notification bell. And I was getting there. You got to let it marinate. They ain't winning. They got to type in IUIC Arkansas and hit the button first. Now that you have done that, because I know that you're not a rebellious Israelite like our forefathers, right?
Hell no.
Surely you've subscribed to IUIC Arkansas by now. So now what you do, you type in Let's Talk Truth, IUIC. And what should pop up is our radio show YouTube, all right? You hit the subscribe button on that and the notification bell button on that. All right, and if you still up, you ain't tired yet, check out the show that we did earlier, all right, Wars in Heaven and Earth. All praise to the Most High God. Y'all got the QR code? Huh? All praise. All Lord. Praise to the Most High, man. Friday Night Raw. This was a hell of an honor, man. Shout out to Deacon ASAP. Double honors to the bishops, the deacons. Right. Shout out to the captains. All praise to the Most High God. All praise to the Most High for our leadership. Deacon been holding this thing down since before I came in. When I came in, he was Friday night. You had to have that password, though. It went streamlined like this. I don't know nothing about that. When I first came in, you had to have that password. But Deacon, he been holding it down, man, for a long time, week after week after. It's rare that anybody would have to fill in. And all praise to the Most High. We had that honor tonight.
Right.
All right. Captain on Friday Night Raw promote. Hey, what I'm supposed to do? I gotta put on, man. You see it? You ask me like it's on. The hell is this? I got to represent. All right. Come on. Y'all still queuing it?
Oh.
What?
I said, oh. All the precepts I know.
All right, so, all right, come on, IT. All praise to the Most High, man. Brothers and sisters was tuned in.
Somebody finna go watch Good Times, Cap.
It ain't out yet, though, is it?
Not an old one.
Oh, okay, okay.
They say, so is it wrong if I go watch the old one? Somebody asked that.
Our people crazy.
Don't fall for it.
All right, there we go, there we go. We're seeking your assistance to enhance our national broadcast. Kindly spare a minute to provide feedback by answering 5 brief questions, like Captain Hoshai say. All right, hit that QR code. Knock that out for us real quick. Somebody said, wait, you still have a couple more hours to go. I gave a disclaimer already, sis. I'm not Deacon ASAP.
Hell nah.
You say, I'm just, you know, just the captain of 100 filling in. All right, well, we taught our topic. It's time to lay it down. All right, but all praise to the Most High. Y'all enjoyed it. All praises. All right, y'all. Hey, Shalom, Most High, Christ bless. Happy Sabbath. Stay in the spirit. All right, Lord's willing. Y'all have subscribed, and y'all will be seeing us on Fridays at 4 p.m. Eastern on Let's Talk Truth, right? With that, we say shalom.